Hi, everybody. Welcome to Windy Hall Stadium. Good Friday night to you. This is VipeFortBend.com coverage of Fort Bend County football. Roger Smith and Patrick Kinnick here to bring you all the descriptions and accounts of tonight's big game between Hightower and Westfield. And Hightower is full of confidence after a great performance last week, shutting out the Bush Broncos. Patrick, you saw that one, I believe. So what can you say about it?
Actually, I did not see that game.
Just go with it. Say you saw it.
I don't want to give any information that I don't really know, but I do think coming off a big win against Bush, they're going to be coming in with some confidence. We'll find out how much.
That's right, and we will find out from both coaches what they are thinking, or at least a little bit of what they're thinking going into tonight's game as we bring you the countdown to kickoff show here on VipeFortBend.com. Our coverage is brought to you tonight by Office Depot, where they take care of business, by Xfinity, the future of awesome, by First Tyrant Automotive, open Monday through Saturday, four great Fort Bend County locations, including Katy Cinco Ranch. Nick's Italian Restaurant on FM 1464, just north of Austin High School. The Needville Insurance Agency. And also Archer Volkswagen, in business since 1956. A great place to buy a brand new car, and they're getting them in ever so slowly, as so many people in the car business are looking for new inventory, but they've got some for you at Archer Volkswagen. So we will step aside and be back and get a visit with Matt Meekins, a man with a very familiar last name. His brother Corby used to coach Westfield and is now on the staff at the University of Houston. Patrick and I will step aside and be back with the countdown to kickoff show on VipeFortBend.com.
Every day, someone comes up to me and says, "Amy, how amazing is Xfinity Internet?" And I always say, "Guys, I could go on and on about how it gives you more than just fast speeds for all your work, school, and everything from home needs, but I have places to be." I'd also mention you can save up to $400 a year on wireless when you add Xfinity Mobile and get nationwide 5G at no extra cost. But I gotta run. I have a thing. Really, it happens all the time. Can your internet do that?
Get started with Xfinity Internet for $19.99 a month for 12 months with a one-year agreement. Plus, save up to $400 a year on wireless over AT&T when you add Xfinity Mobile. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay. Ends 10-18-21. Restrictions apply. New Performance Starter Plus Internet customers only. Equipment, taxes and fees extra, and subject to change. After term, regular rates apply. Savings based on optimized pricing. Xfinity Internet required.
Welcome to the countdown to kickoff show, Friday night, and this is VipeFortBend.com coverage of the game between Westfield and Hightower. And it's time to talk with Matt Meekins, head coach of the Mustangs. They've had a strong program for several years. What are some of the things that you want to get done tonight that you must do better than you did in week one?
Well, we did a good job for about 3.5 quarters of protecting the football last week. For about half of the third quarter, about the second half, we turned it over 3 times. So just want to take away giving the opponent the football.
Well, let's take a look at the Hightower Hurricanes. You know, they've been a team on the rise. They're in a very tough district. But in scouting them, what do you think are the things that you must stop them from doing in order to get the victory tonight?
Well, no matter who you play, you've got to be able to run the ball and stop the run. Now, teams on either side of the ball can all out, sell out, and stop the run, which makes you susceptible to the pass. So my philosophy is stop the run on defense. Don't give up the big play. Offensively, be able to run the ball and take what the defense gives you.
Now, one thing that, you know, they talk about down here is how tough the district is that Hightower plays in, but I don't suppose that you would want to hear it. You play in a very tough district. Describe the type of teams that you have to get through to get one of those four playoff spots.
Oh, you know, our district's pretty tough. You got the Spring School, you got the Davis School, so it's always competitive. You got a lot of good coaches, a lot of good strategies going on, so you got to stay on top of your game.
So who has to be productive for you on offense? Who has to make some plays if you are to be a winner tonight?
Well, you know, all starts up front with the offensive line. When the O-line works, the quarterback works, the running backs work. So, you know, give the quarterback a little time to throw, give the running backs a little crease and see what happens.
We're talking with Matt Meekins, head coach of Westfield, and I'll let this be the last question. Sometimes these pre-district matchups, I often kind of wonder how they came up. Sometimes it's in a big meeting room when someone says, who needs a game on September whatever. How did Hightower and Westfield end up playing a series?
I knew Hightower needed a game, so I called Coach Sam, and he agreed to play us. So I talked to Coach Anthony yesterday. Actually, this morning, we're going to continue this on for the next couple years as well. So I think it's, you know, a lot of talent on both sidelines, a lot of good coaching on both sidelines, and just fun to be out here on a Friday night.
And if you don't mind, I thought of one more thing. Ramon Chin Young is now leading Willow Ridge in his second season. I know he's got Westfield roots. Anything that you want to say to Coach Ramon Chin Young?
I know they got canceled last week, so if you're playing tonight, you know who I'm pulling for.
Yeah, they're playing tomorrow night right here against Dulles.
Oh, sweet. Well, Coach Chin Young was a great player for us and an even better coach for us, and he was a hell of a player, so best wishes to him.
Great. Thank you very much. That's Matt Meekins. Appreciate you spending some time with us.
Yes, sir.
And we'll be back as the countdown to kickoff show continues, and we'll visit with Cornelius Anthony, head coach of the Hightower Hurricanes, who is leading the team in his second varsity game as head coach. Pretty successful last week. Got a shutout against Bush, 26-0. And we'll talk to Coach Cornelius Anthony when we return.
Archer Volkswagen Showroom is open, and our team's excited to help you. Visit our sales department Monday through Saturday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Or bring your car in for service from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Friday, and Saturdays from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. We're closed on Sundays to rest and recharge with our families, so we can serve you well through the week. We hope to see you soon.
Hi, this is Mariela.
And Melina, coming to you from Nick's Italian Restaurant, where you can come and try one of our house specialties, the Nick's Shrimp, or one of our chicken pistachios. Not in the mood for food? You can also try one of our savory desserts, like our homemade tiramisu or cannoli.
We're located on FM 1464, just north of Austin High School.
Can't dine in? You can call ahead at 346-401-1546 7 days a week from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Or you can hit us on one of the major delivery platforms, Uber, Grubhub, or DoorDash.
We look forward to seeing you here at Nick's Italian Restaurant, where our family gets bigger every time you stop by.
Welcome back to the Countdown to Kickoff show. We're just about to get kicked off with Hightower and Spring Westfield. And here to introduce himself and the members of his officiating crew is tonight's referee.
Richard Brenniger. Head linesman is Jacob Brenniger. Line judge is Frank Young. My umpire is John Barker. My side judge is Cedric Jones. My field judge is Nick Stanley. And my back judge is Billy Bell.
Outstanding. Thank you, Mr. Brenniger. Have a good game tonight. We'll be back with our visit with Cornelius Anthony, head coach of the Hightower Hurricanes, when we continue on VipeFortBend.com.
It's that time of year where you hear people using the S word. September, that is. Occasionally, you can hear the great employees at First Tire and Automotive using another S-word with customers. Savings. Fall specials include 50% off an oil change. Now's the time to make sure your auto is ready to kick off the season in tip-top shape. Head to the website firsttireandauto.com and claim your savings. First Tire and Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vipe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugar Land and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. firsttireandauto.com.
Everything. We take care of you so you can take care of business. Office Depot Office Max.
Taking care of business. Hello, fans. This is Bradley Stavenaugh with Needville Insurance. We know Fort Bend County. I'm a fourth-generation resident of Fort Bend. I'm your local, hometown, trusted agent. With over 30 carriers and 9 auto insurance carriers, we shop the insurance for you. We know insurance is hard. We know it's complicated. We make it easy for you. We have Spanish speakers here available for you. Call us at 979-793-7411 or needvilleinsurance.com. Once again, call us 979-793-7411.
Welcome back to Hall Stadium, and the countdown to kickoff show continues. Time to talk to Cornelius Anthony, who is undefeated in his career as the head coach of the Hightower Hurricanes. Got the win last week, 26-0 over Bush. But Coach Anthony, after I heard you talking to the team after the Travis scrimmage, and I'll bet you said some similar things after you played Bush. There's so many things that your team can do better. You're a long way from playing your best football, and when you do, look out to your opponents.
Yeah, we have a very talented group of kids. One of the things that I really appreciate about this group is that any play can be a big play. You know, we're a big play potential, you know, is out the roof, out the meter. So that is very exciting to know that, you know, yeah, we might stall out, but at any given moment, a big play can happen and we can score points or, you know, get a big play on defense or create a turnover. So that's what I love about this group of kids, is that we're just a big play waiting to happen.
And I know you like to demoralize the other team. If they do real well against you on first and second down, you in fact maybe even make you look bad, but then you pop one of those big plays, man, that is discouraging to a defense.
One of the things that we always say, you know, is that we're trying to win the big play ratio, and if we can create turnovers on defense, then that cancels any big play that they have made on offense. And like I tell them all the time, being a defensive minded person, a defensive coach, if they drive 99 yards and we create the turnover, it's like the 99 yards never happened. And so we're always looking for the big play. We're always trying to be opportunistic. And same thing on offense. You know, if we just first downs equal touchdowns, and that's our mantra. That's what we go by. So I'm excited.
And I know you came out of the first game with a clean bill of health. So everybody's going good. And is there anybody who has surprised you, someone that you really didn't think would be contributing as much as they are, who's made a big difference?
I'm going to tell you a kid who really is just winning my heart, and that's Kendrin Pinson Jr., our quarterback. He's a sophomore, first time starting on varsity, and he had a phenomenal game. He had like a 66% passing percentage, completion percentage. Had the second longest touchdown in school history in a 96-yard pass to Zion Kearney. He's another guy that, a super sophomore, I like to call him. And so Kendrin Pinson Jr. is a guy to watch. I want to see what he does against this team, because they have a great defense, very stout defensive line, fast linebackers. And so to me, this would be the litmus test as to whether he's ready for varsity football or not.
Nice little trial by fire. Final question here for Cornelius Anthony. I know that to a head coach like yourself, really all that matters is what happens inside the lines out there tonight, and also in the heads and the hearts of your players. But this is the Friday Night Football Frenzy game of the week. Does that matter to you? Do you mention it, or do you just pretend that big local tune news van is not over there?
No, I let them know. I let them know off the top, because I want them to know the stage is set. You know, this is why you play this game. It's to not only be there for your brothers, but to get the recognition and that you deserve. You work hard in the quiet or behind the scenes for a stage like this. Not go out there and rock the crowd, you know, and let people know who you are and put Hightower on the map.
Well, it makes it a little more fun for me. I'm sure it makes it a lot more fun for the fans. So good luck tonight. You did great last week, and looking forward to seeing what you do against Westfield.
Thank you so much.
All right, Patrick Kinnick and I will be back with the starting, well, we don't have the starting lineups. We'll just kick off the game. So we're ready to go. We've waited long enough. We've worked hard enough all week. Let's play football. Westfield and Hightower, our second broadcasted game of the week here on VibeFortBend.com. And don't forget, tomorrow night we will have Dulles taking on Willow Ridge starting at 5:45. We'll be right back.
Every day someone comes up to me and says, Amy, how amazing is Xfinity Internet? And I always say, guys, I could go on and on about how it gives you more than just fast speeds for all your work, school, and everything from home needs, but I have places to be. I'd also mention you can save up to $400 a year on wireless when you add Xfinity Mobile and get nationwide 5G at no extra cost. But I gotta run. I have a thing. Really, it happens all the time. Can your internet do that?
Get started with Xfinity Internet for $19.99 a month for 12 months with a one-year agreement. Plus, save up to $400 a year on wireless over AT&T when you add Xfinity Mobile. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and autopay. Ends 10/18/21. Restrictions apply. New Performance Starter Plus Internet customers only. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra and subject to change. After term, regular rates apply. Savings based on optimized pricing. Xfinity Internet required.
All right, Patrick, this is what we worked for, to be here on Friday night and enjoy a good football game. Hightower is the home team. They're wearing the forest green pants, the black jerseys with the silver numbers, and the helmets this year are black. And over there on the Westfield side, they kind of look like a combination of Nebraska road uniforms and Texas Tech road uniforms, because they have the bright red pants and the white jerseys with the red numerals, but the helmets are black. You know, Westfield is one of those teams that over the years they've had so many quality teams, but as it is so hard to do, it's hard to get out of the Houston area, but in their region too, they not only have to play some tough teams out of the Houston area, such as the Woodlands, for example, and some of the Klein schools, but then they have to head up to the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex, and there have been a couple of years where they would win a game or two against a team from what you'd call the DFW, but then eventually they would lose out and not quite make it to AT&T Stadium.
Well, you're talking about a pretty good tradition for the school, and we'll find something out this evening, which what we got going here for both teams. I don't know the result of Westfield's first game.
I'm glad you brought that up, Patrick.
Thank
because
you.
They were pretty impressive winners, 37-10 over Strake Jesuit.
Okay.
And Strake Jesuit never has a bad football team.
Well,
They usually are very competitive.
Yeah, I think Strake was looking for a pretty good season this year, so I would think that would be a pretty formidable opponent in game one.
Kaishun Smith and Julian Payne are the captains for Hightower. And Hightower has won the toss. Actually, Westfield won the toss, but deferred. And so Hightower will get the football first at the north end of Hall Stadium. And Patrick, you know, we've had a couple of situations here at Hall Stadium this year already where we look down at one end and we see the flags are just not moving at all.
Yep.
But up here where we're sitting, we feel a little bit of a breeze. So if there is a breeze at all, I'm thinking it is somewhat in the faces of the Hightower Hurricanes as they get their first offensive possession.
Yeah, the flags are fluttering ever so slightly right
ever
now.
Ever so slightly.
But it is blowing toward where with the kicker here, he's going to have a little bit of a wind to his back.
Santana Wilson, Andreas Misik-Duncombe, and Jaden Adams. And Andreas, I think I'm just going to call you Andreas because I'm not sure I can say your first name correctly. Kicking off for the Westfield Mustangs is Jonathan Dimas. He's just a sophomore, gets a foot into the football, and we are underway. He got all of that one. It lands in the end zone and skitters back onto the part of the track and field facility where I guess they would have either the high jump or, well, something. would have some. At either end, you have a whole lot of that all-weather rubber.
Yeah, I've got like a little semicircle there for on both sides, and that was your basic line drive, get up and get out of here, kickoff there. No chance for a return.
So I guess we're, what would you say, a good maybe 50 feet above the playing surface, but down there closer to the surface. Maybe the wind is much stronger, or maybe he just has a very strong leg. Kendren Pinson is the quarterback for these Hightower Hurricanes. I believe that's Dylan Sublett at running back behind him, but first play, Pinson's going to throw deep over the middle. Post! Pass caught! First down and still going inside Westfield territory, down to the 41-yard line. That's a 34-yard pickup as he got it to number 15, Jaden Adams. That's a first down. Think of First Tyrant Automotive for all your car care needs. Check them out at firsttyrantauto.com. And Hightower will not huddle. In motion goes their tight end, Elijah Jones. Pinson, just a sophomore. His coach talked about him in the pregame. He steps up in the pocket, avoids a sack, keeps going, and he only gets 3 yards, but a great job there and pushed back rather rudely, I should say. Keymond Emelian, that's a senior for Westfield, trying to let the sophomore know his place in the pecking order.
He gave him a little bit of a love tap at the end there, a little shove. You could have, if you wanted to be really picky, you could have maybe called a penalty on that. But the referee opted to just separate him and not make too big of a deal out of it. Pretty good form tackle there.
By the way, we want to make sure we monitor the audio. The Hightower band sounds awesome tonight. They are so loud that we want to make sure that you can at least hear our words. Empty backfield on second down, and let's call it 8. Pinson steps up. He's hit. He's sacked. Loss of 5. And guess who got him? Keymond Emelian, who was giving him the love tap one play before.
I think he was saying, I'm going to be here all day today.
All day,
all night.
Baby.
Just don't get too comfortable back here. He was in on that play pretty quick. It was a pretty heavy rush by Westfield there. Several players in on that.
By the way, Patrick, I forgot to tell you that during the game, my son Wesley and or my good friend Kevin Lovell are going to be arriving. So, sorry about that. But at some point, I'll be saying hello to them, maybe in the middle of an important play. Third down and 13, empty backfield again. Pinson drops back, stands strong, steps out, far sideline or near sideline, and a flag comes in as the pass calls incomplete. Jaden Adams was open. He had to come back for it. It was a little underthrown, and he nearly got his head taken off. That was one of those things where the defensive back did not realize it had been underthrown and thought he was beat for a touchdown, so he's thinking, I better prevent a completion here.
Yeah, he was. Adams was open by about 5 yards there, and the ball was, like you said, slightly underthrown, perhaps into the wind a little bit here, and the defender basically tackled him prior to the ball getting there, and it was a pretty easy call for the referee to throw the laundry on that one.
And the defender was either Travian Flanagan or Lamond Wiley. I'm not sure which one it was.
It was Flanagan, I believe.
Okay, thank you.
Yep.
Father Flanagan.
Bringing back the past.
First and 10 from the 30. Two receivers make it 3 on the right side of the formation. And there's a running play up the middle. Good yardage. Inside the 20, still going. He didn't go down. And he's going all the way for a touchdown. It's Jeremy Payne. And he goes in from 30 yards out. No flags, and it's a touchdown for the Hightower Hurricanes.
What a run. He didn't give up there. He got tackled or appeared to be tackled after a 10-yard gain, but he fell on other players. He fell on the defensive players. His knees never touched the ground, and to his credit, kept the legs going and kept on going.
What have you got to lose? Even if the officials do say you're down, they'll just blow the whistle, but
great
you might
job.
As well keep on going.
Good and drive.
Lamond Wiley is injured for Westfield, but it doesn't look like it's too serious. He was kind of stretching, you know, the inner thighs there in that frog stretch.
Yep.
Now he has gotten to his feet, and their head trainer, Susan Davis, along with Chris Grasty, are there just to make sure he's okay. And he's walking off. I think he's going to be all right.
He wanted to go in.
Yeah, he wanted
to
stay
there.
In to defend the extra point, but they said you got to come off
for
at least one play, or we would have to burn a timeout, and that would be silly.
Right at this point.
Well, it looks like Hightower's going to go for two instead of kicking it. And they've got their big power back, Frederick Hankins, in the power eye. Dylan Sublett also out there. Here's the snap, and it's a play-action pass, slant over the middle, broken up very nicely. DeQuarius Calhoun of Westfield prevented the two-point play. Hightower leads it 6-0. We'll be back. This is VipeFortBend.com, 9:30 to go in the first.
It's that time of year where you hear people using the S word. September, that is. Occasionally, you can hear the great employees at First Tire and Automotive using another S word with customers. Savings. Fall specials include 50% off an oil change. Now's the time to make sure your auto is ready to kick off the season in tip-top shape. Head to the website firsttireandauto.com and claim your savings. First Tire and Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vipe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugarland and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. firsttireandauto.com.
You know what that was, Patrick? That was your Archer Volkswagen touchdown drive. And it went 75 yards and only took 2.5 minutes. And scoring the points for these Hightower Hurricanes was Jeremy Payne. Anything else to say about that drive?
No, Coach Cornelius Anthony had talked about big plays, wanting to make big plays, and they had a couple of big plays in that drive, 34-yard pass and a 30-yard touchdown.
All right, the outstanding athlete Caleb Douglas, he can do a lot of things on a football field. He kicks off. He is left-footed. He gets it in the air. It's not very deep. Comes down at the 14 where Calhoun has it. Up the middle, good return. Gets across the 30, near the 34, just short of that point where he's brought down by Hightower's Skyler Robinson. And that's where the Westfield Mustangs will set up their first drive here on VipeFortBend.com. Hightower leading it by a score of 6-0. Nice and steamy here, Patrick. You want to know what the temperature is?
I'd love to know the temperature, but it's not too bad with a little breeze.
No, it's pretty comfortable if you're not playing football, if you're watching it. 82 degrees with a little bit of a breeze. There is a quick pass out to the side and a tackle for loss. Okay, let's unpack that one. It was quick. John McGee made the play for the Hightower Hurricanes. It is a 3-yard loss as the quarterback for Westfield, Cardell Williams, immediately released it. It was actually a backwards pass, so that should be negative rushing yardage. And I didn't see who actually caught it because he wasn't standing up for very long. Second and 13, and now a counter play over the left side. Breaking some tackles and getting the 3 yards lost back, plus one more, was Taji Atkins. And it'll be 3rd down and 9 for the Westfield Mustangs.
I believe he was the guy who had that first pass play, too, to that little flare play pass. Like you said, it was a backward pass, or really it was a run play.
Williams looking at the defense. Still has Atkins in the backfield behind him. And there is a false start by the right guard for Westfield. That'll back him up. That's Isaac Rodriguez. He is a sophomore. You know, there are two players in this game that I would say have an awesome future, and Xfinity and Comcast are the future of awesome. So how about Kendren Penson, the Hightower quarterback, and also the fine right guard, Isaac Rodriguez. Now it's 3rd down and 14. Dropping back is Calhoun. Steps up and throws it. He's got an arm. He's got a completion inside the 25 to the 22 as he delivered a strike to Chucky Hines. Wow, that was a great catch. By the way, you got Chucky Hines and Rechuk Hines. It's got two U's, although it might be Chucky. There's another quick release. They run that same play they did on the first play, and this time it is productive, about an 8-yard pickup as they deliver it to Taji Atkins off the right side, ran up the numbers. And now Westfield, you know, they got their explosive play. And I was really impressed, man, with the arm of Cardell Williams.
Yeah, he laid it in there perfectly on that long pass play.
And what a tight spiral. I mean, right on target. Second down and two, fake handoff, little throw out in the flat, and a completion and a first down at the four. It is Chucky or Chucky Hines. You know when the coaches go by at halftime when they leave the press box to go to the locker room? We need to ask him how to say that name.
That would be
I'm just
very
call
appropriate.
Him, yeah, I'm going to call him Hines for right now. But he is not slow as Ketchup.
No.
First and goal at the four. Williams fakes a handoff, rolls to the right, gets outside the numbers, and just slips and falls down at the nine. And I don't know if that was a business decision. Maybe he was just saying, you know, I'll live to fight another play. So at second and goal, just outside the nine. Great pursuit there by the Hightower Hurricanes defense. Closing in on the 6.5 minute mark of this first quarter. Roger Smith and Patrick Kinnick with you here. It's VipeFortBend.com, and it's 6-0 Hightower, but Westfield has been impressive in moving down the field on its first possession. Out of the pistol, Taji Atkins behind Williams, and he runs to, no, it's a fake, it's a keeper, and Williams throws back in the end zone, batted down, incomplete. Hightower is disappointed that Jamarian Ferguson didn't get the interception, but they got to be happy that they prevented the touchdown. There was a whole lot of cross traffic there in the back of the end zone. And what a great play there by Jamarian Ferguson.
There was a great fake, too, by Westfield there. That he had three receivers that appeared to be open. I think he waited just a touch too long to make the pass.
Third and goal just outside the nine. Empty backfield. Three receivers on the left, two on the right. And Williams steps over and looks at the bench. Play clock is at 7. Now he steps up, has instructions. Better hurry. 4 seconds on the play clock. 3, 2, now they get it snapped. Williams has time, surveys the defense, rolls to the right, throws, and it's incomplete. And Hightower has held on third down, and we'll see, will Westfield kick a field goal? I think they will, because I was down on the field at warm-ups. Their kicker's got a leg. I mean, big, strong leg.
They didn't hesitate. They had the field goal kicking team on almost immediately when the ball was incomplete. Great rush by Hightower. They had about four guys in pursuit of quarterback Williams there.
It'll be a 27-yard attempt from the right hash mark for Xavier Todd is the holder. And the kicker we saw before on the kickoff was Jonathan Dimas. And it's a late snap and now whistles. Hold on. I think that maybe there was a little bit of movement on the offensive side before the snap of the ball. Yep, false start is the signal from the line judge as he walks up and tells our referee, whose name is Richard Briniger. Okay, so they called that penalty on Brian Eshmond, E-A-S-H-M-O-N-D. And with the kind of leg that their kicker Jonathan Dimas has, I don't think it's going to bother him too much. It's now going to be a 33-yard attempt again from the right hash, and the holder is Xavier Todd. Good snap and hold. He gets it away. Wow, that's a rainbow.
That thing is
and
still going
right
up
down the middle. Yeah, that's a beauty. This kid's got a future. You know, maybe we should say that he is the one with an awesome future.
No kidding.
Brought to you by Xfinity and Comcast. We'll step aside. Hightower's lead has been cut to 6-3. We'll be back with 5:59 to go in the first quarter.
Archer Volkswagen Showroom is open, and our team's excited to help you. Visit our sales department Monday through Saturday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Or bring your car in for service from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m., Monday through Friday, and Saturdays from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. We're closed on Sundays to rest and recharge with our families, so we can serve you well through the week. We hope to see you soon.
Hi, this is Mariela.
And Melina, coming to you from Nick's Italian Restaurant, where you can come and try one of our house specialties, the Nick's Shrimp, or one of our chicken pistachios. Not in the mood for food? You can also try one of our savory desserts, like our homemade tiramisu or cannoli.
We're located on FM 1464, just north of Austin High School.
Can't dine in? You can call ahead at 346-401-1546 7 days a week from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Or you can hit us on one of the major delivery platforms, Uber, Grubhub, or DoorDash.
We look forward to seeing you here at Nick's Italian Restaurant, where our family gets bigger every time you stop by.
Well, folks, you didn't miss a thing during that commercial break, except a non-returnable kickoff by Dimas. He cleared the end line.
Yeah, that time.
I mean, he got it up in the air, and what wind that we have has really, truly backed up the Hightower Hurricanes, and it's a touchback. And we welcome to the broadcast table, although there are not enough microphones to go around, my son Wesley has chauffeured my friend Kevin Lovell to the ball game. And now Hightower with his second possession. Quarterback draw, Penson makes a move on a DB, gets outside the 30, now up to the 40, and he's got a first down. And correction, that's not Penson. They bring in Shandon King for the change of pace, and he runs for a first down for Hightower. That's a first down. Think of First Tyrant Automotive for all your car care needs. Check them out at firsttyrantauto.com. From the 40-yard line, fake handoff, and Shandon King runs right, but he is dropped like a bad habit in the backfield. Jaquiel Carr brought him down on the tackle for loss. It'll be second down and 15. Patrick, Kevin, who just walked in and stands behind us right now, is the reason that you'll be calling tomorrow night's game solo. I won't be here because he's going to Austin with me, and we're going to cover the Longhorns game against Louisiana for El Paso Television.
Oh, my goodness. You're going to be big time tomorrow.
Well, I don't know. If you say so. First game for Steve Sarkisian of Texas. And now back into the game is Penson. His snap was kind of high. He faked a handoff, and then he got buried. There were Westfield guys all over the place, Anthony Holmes as well as Braylon Wyatt.
Anthony Holmes is one of those guys who wears a small number. He wears a small number, but he's not a small fella. He's a big defensive lineman, and he met the quarterback pretty much as soon as he made a fake.
By the way, speaking of fella, the reason our listeners heard a little, you know, an unpleasant sound was because I bumped the wire that holds our crowd mic because I was hugging the fella, my younger son, Wesley, who's back for a visit during his sophomore year at Letourneau University in Longview. Third down and 20 to go, and dropping back is Penson, and all of a sudden, the Hightower offensive line is not able to contain the Westfield rush. And you can tell, Patrick, those are some big boys up front Westfield.
It was Holmes again, Anthony Holmes, along with a couple of other guys. What's interesting about this particular drive, the first play was a 15-yard gain by the quarterback, King, and then they lost 5 yards. 5 yards and 5 yards. They've lost all 15 yards in the next three plays.
So if the approach is to get some explosive plays, unfortunately Hightower has had some implosive plays.
Yeah.
Because that Westfield defense is getting a push up the middle. Now Caleb Douglas on to punt. Up into the wind, and the wind knocks it down a little bit. In fact, it takes a Westfield roll. And it landed at the 40 of Westfield, but was killed at the 42-yard line. Make it the 43, and that's where the Mustangs will start on the left hash, going right to left here in this first quarter. By the way, Kevin, I don't have a chair for you other than that one. Okay. Did Wesley go on home? Okay. All right, so here we are, first and 10 for Westfield, trailing 6-3, and now a little reverse action and a big play right here as they handed it off kind of up the middle, but taking it to the outside was DeMario Sheffield, and late in the play, Patrick, in comes the yellow laundry.
Right at the tackle, so I don't know if it's could be his face mask in there, or I don't know, but it was right where they spot the ball here.
Okay, so there are Hightower coaches trying to help the officials. Isn't that nice of them?
Of course, yes.
They're saying, you need to penalize it that way.
Well, the Westfield players are starting to walk backwards, so. Chop block or illegal block downfield, or he gave him the clip, the old clip indication.
Yeah, I grew up with the term clipping. I know you did too,
yeah.
But we just don't hear it that often. We hear way too many syllables like illegal block in the back,
so they,
which used to be clipping.
Yeah, basically they go back to the line of scrimmage for second down.
Yeah, it's much ado about nothing. It's second down and 10 and a half yards.
Wouldn't it be still first down, though?
Well, the down box says second, but there is going to be a first down run.
Wow.
How about that? Cardell Williams handed it off to DeQuarius Calhoun. No, it wasn't DeQuarius Calhoun. Sorry about that. It was Taji Atkins. And that does move the sticks. They are now in Hightower territory at the 46. Williams looking right, throws, and got a completion inside the 30. Fighting, breaking tackles, taking it all the way down to the 26 is Chucky Hines. And Westfield not going to huddle. They're just going to line it up and run something. We're inside 2.5 minutes to go in quarter number one. Hightower leading 6-3, but Westfield's offense has been very impressive. They just weren't able to get a touchdown on that first possession. Play fake, quick pass, broken tackle inside the 15-yard line. Wow, that's DeMario Sheffield, his second catch.
Well, they're showing some stuff out here, a little combination of running and passing, and they've got success going on every play here.
And they're very efficient in getting the ball snapped again, because so there's no way that Hightower can make substitutions. Fake to Atkins. Williams keeps it, going around the outside, gets to the edge, outside the numbers, still going, fights to the 8-yard line. Where tripping him up was Ephraim Dotson. And it's now second down and goal from the 8. No, correction, Patrick. It is, sorry about that. It's not second and goal. It's second and 6. They have to get to the 3-yard line, the 2-yard line, to get a first down. And now we're at 1:22 to go in the first quarter. And there's the fake to Atkins. Williams up the middle, fighting, and easily gets into the end zone. Touchdown for Hightower from 8 yards away.
Well, that was a good run. He's a big quarterback, and like you said, it was a draw, and he had some room, and he wasn't affected by some of the contact that was laid upon him on his way to the end zone. Good job by Cardell Williams, passing and running.
Yeah, he seems like a guy with a great football IQ. He just seems to know how to read that spread option, when to keep, when to run, when to look downfield for a receiver. Demas with the extra point, and that was just as impressive as his field goal. High and beautiful, and
yeah, you could,
right down the middle.
Yeah. You can tell how good a kicker is a lot of times how high they kick it. It's unbelievable.
Unblockable. Okay, we'll be back. Our new score, Hightower leads it 10-6. We'll return on VipeFortBend.com.
Hello, fans. This is Bradley Stavenaugh with Needville Insurance. We know Fort Bend County. I'm a fourth-generation resident of Fort Bend. I'm your local, hometown, trusted agent. With over 30 carriers and 9 auto insurance carriers, we shop the insurance for you. We know insurance is hard. We know it's complicated. We make it easy for you. We have Spanish speakers here available for you. Call us at 979-793-7411 or needvilleinsurance.com. Once again, call us 979-793-7411.
1:12 to go in this first quarter, and the Westfield Mustangs have broken out on top. This is a really good test, I think, Patrick, for Hightower. And in our countdown to kickoff show, Coach Matt Meekins of Westfield said that he and Coach Anthony have talked about continuing to play each other year after year in pre-district. I think it would be good for both teams.
Most definitely.
Demas, well, he kicked that one beyond the end line in almost the exact same spot. Wow. And we have a whistle. What's going on over there? So there was a little bit of contact after the whistle was blowing. Let's say a Westfield player and a Hightower player continued to dance after the music had stopped. Actually, the music never really started because it was a kickoff out of the end zone. My sharp-eyed son, Wesley, spotting that for us. No flags. Good discretion, I think, on the part of the officiating crew.
Well, the third series in a row that Hightower is going to start up their own 25 thanks to the deep kickoffs.
Fumble. There is a delay play and a fumble in the backfield, and it's Penson who has to jump on the football after he, I think he wanted to give it to his running back Brendan Eaglin, but Eaglin, I guess, thought it was a fake, and it ends up being a three-yard loss, and it's second and 13.
Well, the last four plays for Hightower, they've lost 18 yards. They've lost yardage each of the last four plays, so they need to kind of right the ship a little bit here and get back on track.
All right, Penson surveying the defense. Hightower offense has been going backwards the last several plays. There goes Eaglin. There is some positive yardage as he gets back to the original line of scrimmage, and that's it. And he was hit hard, but he wanted to bounce up and make sure that no one on the defense thought that he was any the worse for wear. Cy Johnson did put a pretty good hit on him, though.
That might be the last play of the quarter as we're under 5 seconds here.
You're
clock
right.
Running.
All right, we shall step aside. It is Westfield 10 and Hightower 6 after one quarter. You're listening to your broadcast home for Fort Bend County Sports, VipeFortBend.com.
Every day someone comes up to me and says, Amy, how amazing is Xfinity Internet? And I always say, guys, I could go on and on about how it gives you more than just fast speeds for all your work, school, and everything from home needs, but I have places to be. I'd also mention you can save up to $400 a year on wireless when you add Xfinity Mobile and get nationwide 5G at no extra cost. But I gotta run. I have a thing. Really, it happens all the time. Can your internet do that?
Get started with Xfinity Internet for $19.99 a month for 12 months with a one-year agreement. Plus, save up to $400 a year on wireless over AT&T when you add Xfinity Mobile. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and autopay. Ends 10-18-21. Restrictions apply. New Performance Starter Plus Internet customers only. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra and subject to change. After term, regular rates apply. Savings based on optimized pricing. Xfinity Internet required.
Guess what, Patrick? I got some good news as we start this second quarter. It is good news for Texas high school football fans everywhere. The High School Scoreboard Live app is back. They introduced a new configuration this year. It stinks. They went back to the old one. I'm thrilled. We'll be able to give you scores all night long. Penson on third down and 10 drops back. They give him time. Throws over the middle, but cannot make the connection. He was trying to get it to Caleb Douglas, who was very well covered along the near sideline. Lamond Wiley, hip to hip and elbow to elbow with him the whole way. And it'll be time for Hightower to punt. You know, on their first possession, Patrick, Hightower clipping down the field,
they
making
sure
big plays in a quick touchdown in 2.5 minutes. But since then, Westfield has made some adjustments or gotten mad or something.
They have straightened up on defense or stiffened up. We got Caleb Douglas.
He's Mr. Do Everything. Good snap. Gets it away, but it's kind of a wobbly kick. Near sideline, lands beyond the 50 and bounces straight up, and it is killed by Dylan Sublett. That was a Paula Abdul bounce straight up.
There you go.
And it'll be Westfield football. Great field position at the 46-yard line. 11:42 to go. We have just started the second quarter. And be with us at halftime. It's going to be awesome because we are going to have one of the lovely and talented correspondents of High School Scoreboard Live, Aaron Hartigan, as our halftime guest. I can't wait.
Well, it'll be something to look forward to. 11:42 to get to that point.
All right, Williams drops back, stands strong, plenty of time, enough to unwrap a sandwich, throws deep, and the ball is knocked away. That time, Hightower had great downfield coverage as Jeremy Strotter was right on top of the intended receiver for Westfield, and I think that was Anthony Cathcart.
Now that time he just heaved it down there, a little bit of kind of try to force that one in there a little bit.
And we think Cardell Williams is throwing into the wind now, and we'll see just how strong his arm is. But this is a running play, and it's a very successful one. Look out, inside the 30, maybe going all the way. It is Rodney Smith, and he tumbles into the end zone with a touchdown for the Westfield Mustangs. No flags. It's a 54-yard score.
Well, I'm trying to figure out who touched him. I think he might have got touched at the 5-yard line. What a hole, what a run. And Westfield's kind of sort of taken charge here after Hightower got the first points of the ball game.
Yep, if the extra point is up and good by Demas, it'll be 17-6. Again, out of the hold of Xavier Todd. Demas bangs it through and continues to ascend into the sky, even well beyond the uprights. It's a ting of beauty, but not for the Hightower Hurricanes as they trail 17-6. We'll be back on VibeFortBend.com.
Hi, this is Mariela.
And Melina, coming to you from Nick's Italian Restaurant, where you can come and try one of our house specialties, the Nick's Shrimp, or one of our chicken pistachios. Not in the mood for food? You can also try one of our savory desserts, like our homemade tiramisu or cannoli.
We're located on FM 1464, just north of Austin High School.
Can't dine in? You can call ahead at 346-401-1546 7 days a week from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Or you can hit us on one of the major delivery platforms, Uber, Grubhub, or DoorDash.
We look forward to seeing you here at Nick's Italian Restaurant, where our family gets bigger every time you stop by.
Yeah! It's that time of year where you hear people using the S word. September, that is. Occasionally, you can hear the great employees at First Tire and Automotive using another S-word with customers. Savings. Fall specials include 50% off an oil change. Now's the time to make sure your auto is ready to kick off the season in tip-top shape. Head to the website firsttireandauto.com and claim your savings. First Tire and Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vibe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugar Land and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. firsttireandauto.com.
Well, Patrick, I expected a touchback on the Demas kickoff. I know you expected the same.
And
that's what
it.
We got. So it'll be Hightower setting up at the 25 again. And I think that Westfield is showing just how good they are on defense, not just up front, but also in the coverage of Caleb Douglas.
Yes, and I was just going to say, it's really quite a weapon to have a kicker who can do that, because defensively, you know, you're always going to have your team pinned to the 25-yard line to start every drive, and it's good to know that.
Penson making sure he has all the gaps covered. Claps his hands together, and a quick swing pass over on the right. Good idea. A little hitch screen that gets outside the numbers, and close to a first down is Jaden Adams. I think he's just short of one. He picked up 9 yards, and they usher him out of bounds by the Westfield bench. We're at Hall Stadium, the only Fort Bend ISD stadium in use for varsity football this year.
Did it not look like he got the first down on that run? I could have swore he passed that line. But I guess his knee must have come down a little earlier. But, yeah, Hall Stadium. Good thing we got Hall Stadium this year, huh?
Mercer still under repair. And there is a quick handoff straight up the middle and a loss of a yard, perhaps two. Jeremy Payne was absolutely buried as soon as he got the football. And that was Travion Payton in on the tackle.
Well, Coach Anthony had talked about the defensive line of Westfield. They're really showing it here the last few series. They can't get much going on,
you know,
the inside of that line.
On that first down play you mentioned, you thought that maybe he had a first down.
Yeah.
And against a defense like Westfield, it's critical that
Absolutely.
You get that first down.
Absolutely.
Because you run it on second and short and you end up with third and longer. Third and three is what they have. Empty backfield. Penson steps up over the middle, throws, and it's incomplete. I think he had to throw that ball a little quicker than he wanted to, trying to get it to Donovan Miller, who was sort of open, but the pass is off target, and it's time for Caleb Douglas who has not caught a pass yet, has he? I don't think he has.
I don't think so, no.
So he's going to come on and punt again.
Not what the Hightower Hurricanes are looking for here the last three series. They've four plays and a punt, three plays and a punt, now three plays again and a punt. This time they'll have their wind to the back here.
Looks like Westfield wants to come after Caleb Douglas, and that's a high snap, and he's hitting the backfield. He's going to have to run for his life. There he goes. He's going to make it. First down across the 40, 45, and out of bounds at the 46, but hold on. There are three penalty flags on the field, and I have a feeling, Patrick, that someone for Hightower was holding. If it's a spot foul, they might still have the first down.
Well, we're going to find out. It was kind of a floating type snap, and Douglas didn't think he could get the kickoff. He probably wouldn't have been able to get the kickoff. And there were three Westfield players ready to wrap him up, but none of them could wrap him up. Once he got out of there, he had the good first down yardage, but it looks like a penalty is going to negate this.
And the Westfield coaches had to be watching, because the deep snapper for Hightower is not whistling the snaps right back to Caleb Douglas.
Yep.
There is a lot of air under it. And they said on the third one, well, let's just go after him. And
yeah.
Douglas knew it was going to get blocked if he had tried to punt it, so he just pulled it down. And good thing for Hightower, he's got such great athletic ability.
Well, now they're, let's see.
Okay.
Oh, that's amazing.
So that's right.
That is absolutely amazing.
It's a spot foul.
Jeez.
And because it was far enough downfield, Hightower has a first down. Not how they drew it up, but they need something to get their momentum back.
Yes, so he was able to get 1 yard or 1 or 2 yards enough so that penalty didn't negate it. What a play by Caleb Douglas.
By the way, Patrick, I'm sure that there's a little bit of oversight. I think the score is 17-6, isn't it?
It is.
The scoreboard says 16-6.
I think it's 17, yep.
I don't think that Demas has missed an extra point. First and 10 from the 36. Penson looks left, now right, now back to the left, and simply throws it away.
Well, he had relentless pressure. There was nothing open. The receivers were covered effectively by the Westfield defense, and then the lineman came hustling through there. And good job, though, by the quarterback, Penson, to just get rid of the ball. That's a heady play by a sophomore.
Well, Penson is getting a little bit of a baptism by fire. He didn't get nearly as much harassment last week against the Bush Broncos. Oh,
I can't imagine.
Caleb Douglas lines up on the far right side of the formation. Three receivers over there. And there's a give to Payne, hit in the backfield, breaks that tackle, picks up about three. Going to be third down and 8. So I guess he only picked up 2.
Yeah, he was hit in the backfield initially. He's able to kind of break away from that, but then hot pursuit brought him down for just a 2-yard gain.
Xavier McCray on the tackle. He's big number 99. He's checking out of the game right now, but he looks like a run stopper deluxe along the defensive line for Westfield.
They got a couple of those guys.
Benson on third down and 8 calls for the snap, drops back. Here comes a late blitz. He gets rid of it near the sideline. Caleb Douglas makes the catch, and he's inside the 45 of Westfield,
boy.
And a flag comes in as they knock him out of bounds. I think that's going to tack on some more yards.
Yeah,
and I think the guilty party, or at least the accused party, is going to be Lamond Wiley.
I'm thinking that was a little ticky-tack there, but I've seen a lot worse than that called on the sidelines for a late hit.
I really like what Penson did there. The late blitz came in off of both corners, and he stood strong and delivered a strike. And there's no better guy to deliver the ball before he has made his break.
They decided to.
Caleb Douglas.
They're going to mark it off. It's the personal foul. Yeah, great job by Penson. You're right. He hung in there. The blitz was right coming. Right when he released it, I believe he got hit. And he threw a strike down there to Douglas, who was open on the sideline. Now tack on 15 more on the penalty.
17-6, Westfield leading Hightower, 8:50 to go before halftime, and Pinson has the Hurricanes in the territory of the Westfield Mustangs. It's a play-action pass, too high for Douglas, incomplete, covered closely by DeQuarius Calhoun. Second down and 10 for the Canes. So Westfield, a 37-10 winner over Strake Jesuit last week. And Hightower, which was playing fast on its first few possessions, looks like they want to slow the game down a little bit. They huddle and break out of it. Pinson steps up, might be changing the play, or at least part of the play, on second and 10. And now there's movement on Hightower because the receiver, Nico Lawrence, on the right side of the formation, took off down the field before it was snapped. So instead of second and 10, it'll be second and 15. Hightower with the football at the 32-yard line of the Westfield Mustangs. Westfield, for those of you who like to know school district history, was the second school in Spring ISD. And after Westfield and Spring High came Decaney, which had a state championship in this century. Pinson drops back, throws near sideline, way too high for Douglas and out of bounds. And there were two defenders down there to make sure it was not a completion. Of course, Caleb Douglas, he's very tall, 6'4". He would have had the height advantage, but even he couldn't reach up and pull that one in.
Yeah, that was well out of bounds. Pretty good coverage by the Westfield defense. Now we got a third and 15. They had something going here. Now they got to come up with something big here on third and 15.
Yep, maybe a screen pass, because Westfield really does come in hard on that rush. Four-man front confronting Pinson, who fakes the play action pass and then tries to get it away, and it's batted down at the line, and Westfield is jumping on it like it's a fumble, but the arm was going forward. It was knocked down.
Well, I believe they called him down or in the grasp.
You know what? You're right,
yeah,
Patrick.
The referee was motioning. He blew the whistle and he motions to the ground as if he's down. Now you got a punt here. You're at the 43-yard line. Fourth and forever.
Fourth and forever indeed. It's fourth and 25 to be exact. And still kind of a slow snap back to Caleb Douglas, but they don't really rush him. Wobbly punt, bounces at the 15, and it's killed at the 8. But you know, Hightower could have milked that a little more. Allowed it to roll inside the 5.
Yeah, he was anxious to field that, and it looked like it was all set to roll for another at least 5 yards, and it was heading toward the sidelines too. So, but I guess he wanted to make sure it didn't go into the end zone. They got him pinned at just inside the 10.
I remember when I was just a wee lad watching a Conroe Tigers football game. I was probably in first grade or second grade, and I was very excited. I thought the Tigers had killed a punt at the 1 yard line. As it turned out, it was the 6.
Well, you got to learn those yard markers the hard way sometimes.
Well, I had to get taller, you know, so I could see better. And they used to kind of make little furrows and put chalk in it back in those days.
Exactly. The chalk. Remember we had to do it. It chalked the fields.
And you could grab a fistful of chalk and throw it in your opponent's face right at the
snap. Oh, you never did that, Roger.
Yes, you did.
Oh, my gosh.
Out of the end zone. Williams drops back. Stan Strong throws behind his receiver. It's incomplete near the 25-yard line. He was trying to get it to Chucky Hines.
Pretty good defense by Hightower there. Number 30, Kizzy. Got his hand up there. He might have at least distracted the receiver there.
You know, I think it's either Kizzy or Kazee. Delayed handoff for these Westfield Mustangs, and they run it out to the 16-yard line. It's a pickup of 6, and that's the first carry for Demir Scott. No relation to Michael Scott of Dunder Mifflin. It'll be third down and four.
Bring it in the classic series there.
Williams rolls out, now looks back to his left, a little throwback screen, and this is going to work for a first down. Big yardage across the 30. There goes Atkins, tripped up. Not Atkins, correction. It's Damir Scott who got his hands on the ball the last time. No correction. It is neither Scott, nor is it Atkins. It's Anthony Cathcart. Deepest apologies to Damir Scott, or to Anthony Cathcart, for misidentifying him twice on one play. But it's a first and 10 at the 36-yard line for Westfield, and Williams hands it off on a delay. That's Scott, hit near the line of scrimmage, but he keeps on driving those legs, and I think he ends up picking up four. Second down and six is getting up off the bottom of the pile was Jaden Chibuzo of Hightower. The Hightower Hurricanes lost in last year's playoffs to Manville. Always tough to play Manville. And they're going to have to do it again because they reside in the same district. Second down and six. Williams, play fake, dropping straight back, looking way down the field. Now scrambling to his left, dodges a tackler and cannot get away from that tackler. It's a sack.
Yeah, like you said, he was looking way downfield. He wanted to make the big play. Couldn't quite find a guy open, and then he looked like he was trying to scramble out of there, and then there was not much room for him to scramble. He might have been better off just throwing it away. Lost 2 yards on the play.
Traylon Baloney made the sack, and he was great last week against Bush. That's the first time we've called his name, but it is a sack, and it's a loss of one to make it third down and seven. Westfield leading 17-6, 5:23 to go in the second quarter. And Williams throws late, and it's incomplete. Probably should have been caught by Dejon Palomo, who had to kind of dig his cleats into the field turf and lean back for the ball, but I think he should have had it. It's incomplete. And you know what? Just like Office Depot does, the Hightower defense has just taken care of business. They needed to get the football back for their offense. And they stop this drive by Westfield after the Mustangs had made an explosive play and a first down.
The receiver, like you said, looked like, I think it was Palomo. He had a chance to make a good catch there. It was a little low, and sometimes when you're running fast down a field and having a stop quick, kind of hard to get that timing in your... Well, there's a punt here. Well,
two safeties back for Hightower. Will they be able to return it? They're going to try from the 22-yard line. And just a net return of 2 yards as Zion Kearney made the catch. And Zion Kearney, last week, the second longest touchdown in the history of Hightower football. He caught a 96-yard touchdown pass from Penson.
Second longest in history.
Second longest.
Well, that's pretty good stuff.
All right, so has Hightower been able to draw something up on the sidelines while they were waiting to get possession of the football to figure out how to fool this Westfield defense that I think has great size, mobility, and great athletic ability? You got to use some finesse here, perhaps. Penson, quick pass. Throws it about four yards down the field. A late flag is going to be pass interference, and I think Patrick is chuckling because I think maybe ticky-tack would be the word you would use to describe it. Caleb Douglas, the intended receiver.
Looked like he had pretty good timing there. He knocked it away. He was a little behind him, so maybe he might have had an arm up on him that we didn't see. We're quite a distance away, obviously. It sure looked like a pretty good play from here.
Okay.
And now they're going to talk about it.
It really
I'm sure
was.
He's getting an earful over there by from the coach of
yes.
the Westfield.
It's not far from the Westfield bench, so I'm sure that Matt Meekins and his staff are singing a chorus of disapproval.
Yes. I think we could be pretty safe to say on that one. Automatic first down. The good news for Westfield, it was just a 5-yard penalty or 6-yard penalty.
Yeah, so on pass interference against the defense in high school, it's either 15 yards or what would have been the length of the completion, whichever is less. Penson hands off to Payne, and he's tripped up in the backfield. He just keeps leaning forward, manages to pick up three, but that's it. In fact, they mark him down after a two-yard pickup, and it's second down and eight. And we've got, right now, we've got 4.5 minutes left in the second quarter. Don't forget our interview with Aaron Hartigan. I think it might be an award winner. I might submit it for some kind of an award. Dropping back is Penson with a quick short pass. And I mean short, it's about a gain of maybe 2 yards as he got it to his tight end, Caleb Davis. Man, there are a lot of Calebs out there.
Popular
this one
name.
Spells his name K-H-A-L-E-B. And it says he's only 5'7".
He looks a little bigger than that.
Yeah, I think that's got to be a misprint or something.
Well, he caught that ball around a 35, maybe the 36, and he bellied back to try to get more yardage, and he ended up with just a one-yard gain.
Did you say he bellied back?
Yeah, bellied back. It's one of the one of the terms we used to use when you
in Wisconsin,
yeah,
I guess. Third and seven, empty backfield. Penson. Wait a minute. There's movement. Nearly everybody on the Hightower side moved except the center, and so that's going to back them up instead of third and seven. It's third and 12.
All the receivers were making their way downfield. Pretty easy call for the line judge. And like you said, it's going to be a third and 12 now for Hightower. So Hightower scores on their first drive of the half, Roger, and they've come up empty the last several drives. Maybe they can finish the half off with a score like they started the half.
I sure hope so, but they got 3:28 to do it, and the clock ticking. Westfield looks like they want to come after Penson. They do. He gets rid of it quickly, far sideline. Caleb Douglas caught it! And he's out of bounds between, I think, the 30 and the 35.
He laid it in there beautifully that time.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful.
And that takes it all the way down to the 30. That's a 40-yard gain on that pass play. So there's a big play, and they're setting up for possible scoring here. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Jeez. Oh,
so there's a near interception as it was Penson trying to throw over the middle, and Hightower's just got to be happy that it's second and 10 and still their football.
Well, that is might want to call that a gift, because, boy, that ball was right in, looked like Dominic Bailey, right in his mitts, and he just dropped it, just simply dropped it. And I'm not sure Penson just flat out didn't see him, because the ball was right in his hands. Lucky for Hightower.
All right, here is Penson on second and 10, dropping back. Here comes the rush, throws late over the middle, and it's incomplete. And it was just another matter of too much harassment. He had to get the ball out of the hands faster than he wanted to. He was looking for Caleb Douglas, and Cameron Phoenix was shadowing him. So it was not to be there.
It doesn't matter who you are at quarterback. You've got guys draped all over you. It's hard to make an accurate pass. And he had a couple of Westfield defenders clawing him and about ready to bring him down on that throw. Third and 10 now from the 30. Just under three to play. I think we've got a timeout here, Roger.
All right, we'll take it with them. 2:59 to go, 17-6. Westfield on top of Hightower, but the Hurricanes trying to fight back here and get a score. We shall return.
It's that time of year where you hear people using the S word. September, that is. Occasionally, you can hear the great employees at First Tire and Automotive using another S-word with customers. Savings. Fall specials include 50% off an oil change. Now's the time to make sure your auto is ready to kick off the season in tip-top shape. Head to the website firsttireandauto.com and claim your savings. First Tire and Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vibe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugar Land and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. firsttireandauto.com.
Archer Volkswagen Showroom is open, and our team's excited to help you. Visit our sales department Monday through Saturday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Or bring your car in for service from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Friday, and Saturdays from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. We're closed on Sundays to rest and recharge with our families, so we can serve you well through the week. We hope to see you soon.
All right, out of the timeout, Hightower trailing by 11 with 2:59 to go. Needs to dial up something that works on third down and 10 against the tough Westfield defense. Penson takes the snap, and it's over his head. He turns around and picks it up near midfield, running for his life to his left. Gets beyond the pass rush, still going inside the 30, and tripped up at the 26. And the Westfield defense responded very well. The guys in the secondary recognized what had happened. Cy Johnson upending the quarterback, Penson.
Well,
the
actually,
line of scrimmage is the 26, and what do you think?
Well, I just want to note that they brought in Shandon King.
Oh, really?
And he was the man who ran that ball after the high snap. He did a great job of getting 5 yards on the player, 4 yards.
All right. Thank you. So it is Shandon King still taking the snaps, and on fourth and six, he tries to go up the middle, and there's just no room there. Wow. 43, Christopher Walker made the first contact, and very soon help arrived, and the Westfield defense squashes yet another offensive thrust by these Hightower Hurricanes.
Well, on that high snap, I just have to say it was one of the best plays of the game by King, who was able to get the ball and then just run for his life. He outran the defensive lineman. But then he ran into some of the Westfield secondary who were able to get him for only a four-yard gain. But that could have been, you know, a 15-yard loss.
You know, since we want to allow lots of time during halftime for our interviews of our distinguished guests, I want to give you some scores, you know, when I get a chance here, as we proceed with the final 2 minutes or so of this first half. But I don't want to give them now because Westfield looks like they're about to run a play. Okay, they've got to reset the clock instead of 2:07 to go. Here's 2:13 remaining before halftime.
Right now they got 21:30 on the clock.
Yeah, that would be too much time.
Yeah, the referee is looking to get extra time put on that clock, and in the meantime, maybe now's a good time to read those scores.
Okay, yeah, you're right. All right, so Ridgepoint beat Dickinson in a thriller that we broadcasted for you last night. Ridgepoint 42, Dickinson 36 at Freedom Field in Alvin, a game that was played at Freedom Field because Mercer Stadium isn't available. And, well, let's just say when I was at Freedom Field, I said to a lady, "Is this heaven?" And she said, "No, it's Iowa Colony." By the way, the Marshall Buffs right here at Hall Stadium last night thrashed the Elkins Knights 49-7. And Marshall, depending on which poll you look at, but the Dave Campbell Texas football poll has them number 3 in the state in Class 5A. All right, here we go. And it is Williams dropping back. Plenty of time to throw, and in the flat off the hands of his intended receiver, Atkins. Incomplete near the line of scrimmage. So, you know what, Patrick? They set the clock at 2:13. It's an incomplete pass, and then they ran off 3 seconds while nothing was happening, and then they stopped it. So I guess the clock is right where it should be at 2:10.
We'll just trust that it is, yep.
Trust. I don't know about trust anymore.
That pass play should have been caught. The receiver looked like he was running a little bit before he caught it, and it went down to the ground incomplete.
Second and 10. Williams throws into the left flat. He's got a completion and a first down, an 11-yard pickup. And Dejan Palomo is absolutely blasted by one of the Hightower defensive backs. And I think maybe that was Ephraim Dotson who made the hit. But it is an 11-yard pickup and a first down. They have it at the 37-yard line in their own territory. Westfield leading 17-6, and now Williams to throw again. Steps up in the pocket and throws it deep down the near sideline, and it is incomplete. Intended for Cathcart. A great battle at the 30-yard line, and Hightower's Jalen Mendez saved the day, knocking the ball to the turf. And so that helps Hightower if they want the ball back and want a little bit of time to be left on the clock when they do get it back. There's 1:46 to go, and, well.
That was a good play by the defender, Mendez, as you mentioned, because the Cathcart was open, just a slightly underthrown on that pass, enough time for him to get back and bat it down.
Williams on second and 10, drops straight back. Looks like he wanted to set up the screen. Now throws the ball into the dirt. And the reason he did that is because it was a great defensive play by Dalen Ellis in the middle of the defensive line for Hightower. He was right there in front of Atkins. And the thing to do was throw it into the ground, which he did.
Well, that's good defense by, you mentioned, it was Ellis. Yeah, he must have been listening at practice for his keys, because he was all over that receiver. No way were they going to complete that screenplay.
Third and 10 with 1:43 to go. Williams half roll to the right, looking way down the field. Still can't find anyone. Throws late and finds a man for a first down. And more than that, inside the Hightower 40 and down near the 30-yard line. He delivers it to Chucky Hines. And I don't see any flags. Do you, Patrick?
No flags. Great play by the quarterback to find his receiver, Hines. And they're in business now with a minute 32 to play inside Hightower territory.
Well, in this Westfield team, I'm seeing a team that could cause a lot of people trouble in the Region 2 playoffs. First and 10 from the 32 for Westfield. The clock says 1:32. High snap. Williams has it. And he's hit. And the ball comes out. And Hightower has it. It's a strip sack. It's a strip sack. And Robert Staten comes through and just put his helmet right into Williams' chest and knocked the ball out. And it was recovered by Hightower with 1:26 to go. Finally, something for the Hightower fans to cheer about.
What a play, and what a time to make the play. It looked like Westfield was heading into the end zone or for more points to try to stamp home the first half here. Now Hightower has the ball with a chance to put some points on themselves and maybe draw a little closer here.
You know what, Patrick? I'm kind of thinking that if Hightower has been working on any kind of gadget play, if they're interested in using a gadget play in a non-district game, this might be the time to do it. You're down by 11. And you just haven't been able to play straight up and beat the Westfield defense. Penson back in at quarterback, drops back, has time, now flushed, now engulfed. He is thrown down by multiple Westfield Mustangs. The first one that got there was Anthony Holmes. He's been tough.
Well, he's had a heck of a first half. He's been all over the place, especially the quarterback. And they just hadn't been able to stop him. 9-yard sack.
And I think Christopher Walker might also get credit for half a sack.
Absolutely, he's right
on
in there
that play.
Too. Yep. That makes it a second down and 19. What do you draw up here?
Oh boy, you better leave an extra guy in to block. But they're going to run the football, and Jeremy Payne's not going to be able to get out of the backfield. He is buried for a loss of one. All over him was Dominic Bailey. And with 53 6/10 seconds to go in the second quarter, Westfield uses a timeout because they want the ball back to try and up the ante. They already lead it 17-6 here. Yep. By the way, here's some more scores for you. Rough start to the season for the Stephen F. Austin Bulldogs out of Fort Bend. They lost to Alief Elsick last night, 22-10, so they're 0-2. Got to right the ship real quick, and the same can be said of the Travis Tigers. You were there as they lost to Foster 28-7, and so they are 0-2.
You didn't need to read that score, but I guess so.
Well, you know, it's kind of like the Abilene Reporter News, the newspaper out there in the town where I went to college. They had this little thing under the the masthead.
Yeah.
In every issue, it said, with or without offense, to friend or foes, we sketch your world
there you go.
Exactly as it goes. So that's why we give you all the scores.
I understand, right?
But, hey, here's some good news. Wash your mind out with this. The Clements Rangers are 2-0. They buried Westbury 52-14. And next week, Patrick, I'm going on the road with them to Pasadena.
All right.
As they try to go 3-0. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, it's third down and 20, and Hightower wanted to run the football. Did they lose it?
I think they did, or maybe he just
if they lost it, somehow Pinson got it back and managed to avoid the turnover. But another timeout taken by Westfield with 46 and a half seconds to go in the half, and this will be a punt situation for Hightower. And let's see, just to let you know, other games that will be happening either tonight or tomorrow. Pearland is at Memorial. Pearland coming off that spanking they took at the hands of the Ridgepoint Panthers in week one. The Woodlands will take on Lamar. Lamar, the last bastion of quality football in Class 6A and HISD. The Crosby Cougars, who had a great year last year but lost so many players. You know, you and I saw them beat Marshall
in
the playoffs.
Game, yeah.
And Crosby's still pretty good, but they did lose a lot of great seniors.
Did they go all the way to the championship game?
They made it all the way. And, of course, guess who was waiting there?
We didn't want to.
Alito.
I don't
team with the coach that wouldn't give you an interview. And it was.
We don't hold any grudges around here.
No, we just remember things. That's all. Class 5A, number 2 ranked Manville Mavericks taking on Crosby. I think that game is tonight. It might be tomorrow, but I think it's tonight. And Rosenberg Terry in a Lamar Consolidated intra-district rivalry. Terry against Lamar Consolidated and Katie Taylor against George Ranch. Okay, now we're back to action. Fourth and 21, actually. Caleb Douglas to punt it away.
Nice kick.
He gets away.
Wow.
A nice kick.
Wow.
And chasing it all the way to the 6-yard line. And now turning around is DeQuarius Calhoun. Calhoun trying to get loose, breaks a couple of tackles.
Oh,
look
goodness.
Out. 25, 30, far sideline, near the sideline, and out near the 40. And the clock keeps ticking, bleeding off extra time, but it's down to 28.2 seconds. And Hightower is going to have to play some defense here because Westfield, I think, is ready to take a deep shot or two down the field.
What's interesting about that whole play, it was an unbelievable punt. I mean, we should probably measure that.
Okay,
what was that?
It was from the 28 at the Hightower end to the 6 over there.
30, that's like 66 yards, basic, almost?
Okay, so that's 22 plus 44. Yeah, 66 yards, exactly.
That's amazing. And then the return, he got all the way to the 39. So what's interesting, if it would have just been a normal punt and a normal return, he'd be right there at about the 39-yard line.
We might be about to see how far Williams can throw the football. He rolls to his right, looking way down the field, keeps it, and runs out of bounds. And the clock stops with 21 and 4 tenth seconds to go as he gets beyond midfield and into Hightower territory at the 48-yard line. Actually, he stepped out a little sooner than that. He stepped out at his own 47, so it's just an 8-yard pickup. And let's see. Westfield still has one timeout in their pocket. So if they can complete something deep in the middle of the field, they can use that timeout.
And they got that strong kicker too, remember?
Oh, yeah. And dropping back as Williams steps up, looking, moves over to his left. Now he's trying to find the sideline, breaks the tackle, and he's brought down. He has a first down at the Hightower 44, and the clock stops to move the sticks, but Westfield goes ahead and calls that final timeout. So I think they'll have a chance to throw the ball deep to the end zone once or twice with 11.2 to go.
It'll be interesting to see what they do, if they try to work for the field goal position or if they try to go into the end zone here. Like you said, they don't have any timeouts, so they got to be careful about where they're throwing the ball. And
you know, you're right about that because they have options. A lot of teams that you see in high school would need to get the ball to about the 20-yard line
right,
to give their kicker a chance. But from what we have seen already from Jonathan Demas, you know, you get the ball to the 30.
Yep.
And I think he could certainly get it between the uprights from there.
And the flags are hanging on the poll right now. And like you said earlier, Roger, it's kind of hard to tell for sure what's going on down in the field. We can feel a breeze up here, and it may not be so breezy down there. We're just not quite sure. But one thing is for sure, their kicker has a strong leg. We'll see what they're going to do from the 45.
By the way, I want to say thank you to Trey Grubb. He is monitoring our sound, and he let us know we needed to turn up the microphones. We don't want to overmodulate, but we don't want to be down in the mud either, as they say in the business. 11.2 to go, and we'll see how far down the field Westfield wants to get the football, or will they try to get into the field goal position. Williams drops back, rolls to his right, and throws a little swing pass. It's going to be a short gain inside the 40 to the 35, and he got it to Xavier Todd, who was wrestled out of bounds by Hightower's Julian Payne. And I think they're going to bring on the kicker. Yes, they are.
Going to be about a 51, 52 yarder.
Let's see here. Yeah, 51. If they do it the conventional way and place it 7 yards behind where the ball is snapped.
Yep.
And it's on the right hash mark. And Demas, you know, you mentioned no wind. It's almost like kicking in a dome. He is on the right hash mark. And it'll come out of the hold of Xavier Todd.
Well, let's see.
I wonder if there have been any 50-plus kicks in high school football in these first week.
Oh, my goodness.
It goes over Todd's head.
Oh, my
goodness.
And
he's still bouncing the ball. It's still loose. Look out. Somebody could scoop that up. It's still loose. Hightower falls on it, and the clock has run out. It is 17-6. That is it for the first half. We'll be back with Erin Hardigan. You're going to love her.
Archer Volkswagen Showroom is open, and our team's excited to help you. Visit our sales department Monday through Saturday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Or bring your car in for service from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Friday, and Saturdays from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. We're closed on Sundays to rest and recharge with our families, so we can serve you well through the week. We hope to see you soon.
Every day, someone comes up to me and says, Amy, how amazing is Xfinity Internet? And I always say, guys, I could go on and on about how it gives you more than just fast speeds for all your work, school, and everything from home needs, but I have places to be. I'd also mention you can save up to $400 a year on wireless when you add Xfinity Mobile and get nationwide 5G at no extra cost. But I gotta run. I have a thing. Really, it happens all the time. Can your internet do that?
Get started with Xfinity Internet for $19.99 a month for 12 months with a one-year agreement. Plus, save up to $400 a year on wireless over AT&T when you add Xfinity Mobile. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay. Ends 10-18-21. Restrictions apply. New Performance Starter Plus Internet customers only. Equipment, taxes and fees extra, and subject to change. After term, regular rates apply. Savings based on optimized pricing. Xfinity Internet required.
Welcome to Halftime, VibeFortBend.com. Another exciting high school game and another exciting halftime, because we have here as a special guest one of the roving reporters on High School Scoreboard Live, Erin Hardigan of Bally Sports Southwest. Welcome in.
First of all, thank you for getting our new name correct. It's great to be with you. First and foremost, and I would like to think I am also your favorite Erin Hardigan, as there are obviously...
You're the only Erin Hardigan in my life. But I realize there are two out there in TV land, and you're one of them.
Yeah, long story short, for those listening here, my Twitter handle is I'm Erin Hardigan, and that is only because the other Erin Hardigan, who also happens to be in the communications field, stole my name, and then essentially the Erin Hardigan Twitter handle. She gets to write about food and drink for a living with the Food Network, which I'm extremely jealous of. So if the other Erin Hardigan is listening, I would love to trade places for a day. You come cover sports, you can hang with him on the sidelines, I will go write about food and drink.
All right. Well, that sounds good. And then you'd get as all you can eat and drink, and that would be fun for you. But I'm glad you're assigned where you are. First of all, let's talk about the different reporters. I know that sometimes on those high demand weeks where there are lots of high school football games and you need reporters for High School Scoreboard Live, you might even bring in some extras. But the regulars who are there all the time are yourself, Katie Engelson, Paige Schnorbach, Sarah Merrifield, who has already been one of our halftime guests. Have I missed anybody?
Austin Ivan is another rising star for us out in the field, as well as Lauren Blackwell. And so we have a slate of stars. Did we forget Greg Tepper? I think I forgot Greg Tepper, and I didn't mean to do that on purpose, but it's probably best because he's like become this mega star on Football Friday. We have to keep his head small. So
yes, well, I think of Tepper as the guy, he's the information guy, he's there kind of the library of Dave Campbell's Texas football is in his head.
Is he Craig Way's young grasshopper? Is that Craig Way's the Miyagi and he's kind of the young grasshopper learner? Is that how it works?
I think it's Craig Way is the Padawan.
There you go. No, it's good. I have spent enough hours on air next to Greg Tepper that I believe in the state of Texas we are legally common law married. No, I mean, we're going on 8 years now that we've been doing this show together. And, you know, people ask us all the time, what it means to be able to do that show. And I will ask you, I will in turn ask you the question, how big is Texas high school football? Here's how big it is. We devote 6 hours of continuous statewide coverage each and every Friday night in the fall. So for 16 weeks, we devote 6 hours every Friday. What other state does that? We cover the passion, the pageantry. It's a different level here in the state. It's almost a religion. And for me, it's such a privilege to get to be part of that.
We're talking with Aaron Hartigan of High School Scoreboard Live. And when I say High School Scoreboard Live, I'm not just referring to the two-hour show. I'm talking about the 6 hours that you just mentioned.
Yes.
Well, the way I would describe it is someone who's been around as long as I have, as long as your ace videographer, Mike Alexander, my former college roommate, it's the kind of program that we would have dreamed about. That we never knew high school football could get that kind of coverage and that you would have that much fun just sitting there in your living room watching all those highlights, all that post-game reaction, all that perspective.
Well, you know, and I think what makes it so cool is it's so significant. What we do is so it resonates with so many across the state and the communities. Okay, because here's the thing. Yeah, we cover the game. We cover the X's and the O's and the highlights. But ultimately, it's the stories. It's the people. It's the communities. It's the traditions. And that is why Texas Football Days has become an annual tradition for us. It's a big kickoff, week-long kickoff every season. We're going on our fifth straight year now, which is crazy to think about. But Texas Football Days is a celebration of everything that goes into Friday night in general. I mean, you think about it, the band plays just as much a part of those games as the fans in the stands, as, you know, the mascot that's getting them going. You see everything shutting down because it's, you know, it's such an event. And I don't know, there's just something so unique about it. And I tell everyone out there, if you have yet to experience a Texas high school football game, please do so. It will change you, right? You've been covering it long enough. We've lived in other states. We've covered preps football in other states. This is an experience that I highly recommend to anyone.
All right, we're talking with Aaron Hartigan. I was trying to think of a really good tease to make you stay and come back after we take this commercial break. I don't think I have to. It's just going to be more stuff. Only better
cool
when we
Aaron
can turn you.
Next.
What'd you say?
The cool Aaron Hartigan. Next.
Is there another kind? We'll be back on VibeFortBend.com.
Are you ready?
Ready for anything. For what life throws at you? At your kids.
Are they ready to study, research, write papers?
To do all the amazing things they don't even know they're capable of yet?
Internet Essentials from Comcast brings affordable, high-speed internet to your home for only $9.95 a month. Now available to low-income households eligible for public assistance programs like Medicaid, the National School Lunch Program, SNAP, housing assistance, and others. Visit InternetEssentials.com to apply. No credit, check, contract, or installation fee. Taxes, extra restrictions apply.
We are back with more of our visit with Aaron Hartigan of Bally Sports Southwest, not Fox Sports Southwest. And she's one of the reporters on High School Scoreboard Live, a show like no other. Wow, I can tell you that when I'm working a game at halftime, I go to my High School Scoreboard Live app and get scores. So after we hear the interview of the special guest, in this case, you, after that interview is over, then we can, it really helps us gather up scores when we're working, especially when it's just me working by myself, because we're never more than a crew of two. But you can't relate to that. You work with, 2,002 people on the show.
And we need that many to keep track of scores statewide at 6A to 6-man. I mean, we cover it all, UIL at least. And I will tell you, I talked about just how different high school football is in Texas as compared to other states. Well, I know that firsthand because I didn't grow up here. I grew up in Omaha, Nebraska. Obviously, Nebraska football is very big up there. But everyone asked me, like, well, how the heck did you get to Texas? A softball scholarship, played all sports growing up. A softball scholarship brought me to West Texas A&M. Coincidentally, the conference that won Roger Smith was in many years ago.
The Lone Star Conference.
Yes, the LSC, and I'm buffs up. I'm on the WT side. Obviously, you're from Abilene Christian, who was there when we played. Fantastic program, by the way. So what's the saying? I got here as quick as I could. I'm not right from here, but I got here as quick as I could, and I just fell in love with it. There's something about the Southern hospitality, I think, that got me. So thankful I'm here. And I loved it so much that, I ultimately ended up moving to Dallas and began working for, I began covering high school football and college football recruiting for scout.com. That's kind of like where I started. And so I traveled across the state, games covering the recruits, the prospects, the stars, right? But along the way, I realized that, other states like Florida and California and Ohio, they have great football because it's star-driven. It's star-studded. In Texas, you have great programs. And I'm talking like these kids are groomed from young ages for these programs. I mean, it's community. It's great teams. And you may not even have you may not have 5 stars and 4 stars and whatnot, but you have great coaching that can make it a well-oiled machine. And that's what I loved about Texas high school football. And so I was lucky enough to get the opportunity to get to be a guest on various shows at Fox Sports Southwest with Rick Renner and Neil Beasley. Oh my gosh, a number of people. And I don't know. I guess I was told I had the gift of gab. And they're like, hey, why don't we stick you in front of a camera on Friday nights along Rick? And you guys can talk football for 6 hours. And I'm like, where do I sign?
Beauty of it is there's a market for it. There are people more than happy to pay you to do that.
And it's a dream. It's like, what? Like, how did I and again, I'm entering my ninth season doing this. And I don't know. Being here, I went to coaching school earlier, this summer. Back in July in San Antonio, I went to coaching school. And it was
That's
then...
That's where I met you, I think.
That is where... That is. Back. We met there. And you and I had a discussion about how that was kind of... That was an experience I had in which I remember... I realized how many connections I've made over the years in this great game. How many great coaches and how... And it's just... I don't know. I guess it's, for me, it's surreal. I still pinch myself. And I feel like that's when you know you're doing what you love, right?
Yeah. Now, let me ask you this, Aaron Hartigan. So many times, if you move to another place after you lived your youth somewhere else, so you come to Texas to play in Canyon at West Texas A&M, and you stay here. But before you got here, Did you watch the television show Friday Night Lights, and did it kind of shape your perception of Texas and high school football?
Okay, I will just say this. Friday Night Lights makes much more sense after living here. I mean, I'm telling you, it was like something I really couldn't grasp, I guess, watching it from afar, not having experienced it. And I remember being, you know, the whether it's the movie or the show, both are great. I highly recommend the television series as well. But Tim Riggins kind of got the.
You like Tim? Is he good looking?
I'm a fan of Tim, and I feel like Tim. I feel like Tim changed. They never really gave him a good. You know, he did. He had chances and he blew them. But I, at the core, I feel like Riggs was a good guy. Anyway.
He really did, at when push came to shove, he often did the right thing.
Yes.
But it was kind of eclipsed by how often he succumbed to temptation.
Another fan of that. You have a better way of explaining these shows than I do, my friend. Love it. So again, I'm sitting there, you know, I'm a kid in Omaha, Nebraska, and it's like life wasn't like that. Like football, at least where I was from, I was like, is it? Like, it's literally their life. Their life revolved, and I'm like, I don't know, I guess it was hard for me to grasp, and then once I experienced it, you know, you're just like, I don't know, everyone, you know what's cool, this is what I'll say, everyone in the community feels like they're a part of it, and you can't say that everywhere else. Everyone in that community feels like they play a part in that program's success in some way, be it the lady making sandwiches for the bus ride, the cheerleaders making the signs, the team's going to run through. I mean, you name it, the PA announcer. I mean, everyone takes such pride in what goes into those Friday nights. And I don't know. I'm just, I love it.
And unlike jobs, which you can switch, you can change jobs. But if you grow up in a town and you're, whether you played or not, if you were invested, as you just described, you'll never be anything else. You will always be from Ennis, and you'll be a Lion. That's it. That's the way it always is.
And yeah, I mean, there's like, you know, there's that pride and that loyalty, you know, and that's what makes the rivalries so great too. It's one big family, Texas high school football, and you find that
some members of the family don't speak to each other, but go on.
And others are a bit more dysfunctional, like myself. But you know what? We're accepted, and we're all there. And you need some of those. You need those quirks in the family to keep it entertaining and interesting. And we have plenty of that here in the state of Texas. I'm curious. I'm such an interviewer that I want to flip this on you, and I want to start like asking you about how you got into it, or what to you makes it so special.
Okay, I can answer that. You know how you never remember not knowing the English language. From the time you started remembering things, you knew the English language. Well, I don't ever remember a time where I didn't know what I was supposed to be invested in. As a little bitty child, you go into that stadium, we're wearing these colors, that's the team we love, and we want them to win real bad. And I've never not understood that concept. And then I can sometimes go to a game as a neutral observer. I don't really know either team. I might not have been to either one of those Texas towns. If it's a high-stakes game where somebody's crying at the end and someone's wildly celebrating, I can watch it and tears come into my eyes. That's how much I love seeing high school sports. And it's not just football, but football is probably the one that brings the strongest emotions up.
Yeah, and it's, I will say this, we've been there, our country, life has been very challenging this past year in a number of different ways. I find that football, and I won't even call, I'll never call it an escape or necessarily even an outlet, because it's like we're not trying to avoid maybe some you know things we're going through, but it's a respite sometimes. And I'll use an example. 2017, Hurricane Harvey. we have our first ever, it's our first ever Texas Football Days week-long celebration, and we're in Idaloo, and we're, you know, it's shallow water in Idaloo, and we're wanting to celebrate the start of Texas high school football season when half the state isn't playing because they're underwater or they're repairing communities. And I'll never forget, I witnessed the banding of an entire state the size of Texas. The entire state, coaches reaching out to coaches, maybe they'd never met, but they're like, you know what? You're part of Texas, so you're part of me, you're part of our family, we're gonna take care of one another. And I was like, you know what? This is what we wanna highlight, right? And it was a respite for those, and we heard from some of the communities that had been affected by it, and they said, football for even just an hour brought happiness, brought just peace or something that brought me joy. And that's when I realized, like, this it's so much more than just the game we watch on the field and the X's and the O's. It changes lives, and it's a melting pot. Sports in general really are, but it's the one time, and this is as a former athlete myself, I will tell you, like, what I take away most is that I learn to work with and fight alongside multiple personalities, backgrounds, upbringings, beliefs. You learn to become one, and that's through sports, and that's truly beautiful to me.
And the only color that matters is the one on your uniform. And I can put a bow on this for you, Aaron Hartigan. You're familiar with the singer Meat Loaf. He was before your time, but he was from Texas. And okay, so his epic album is Bat Out of Hell. And on the title cut, there's a certain line in it. You know, you kind of described how sometimes the world is in turmoil or turned upside down, or there's a lot of contention over one thing or another. There's a line in that song where he says, "Baby, you're the only thing in this old world that's pure and good and right." So when I think of high school sports, I know they're not perfect, but they are sincere, they're born out of love, and that's why I never get tired of being a part of this stuff. So I know you feel the same way.
Why do you always have the best way of putting things? Where does that come from?
I don't know.
I'm putting him on the spot over here. No, listen, we love it. A note here again, if just tuning in, Football Friday, each and every Friday night on Bally Sports Southwest, beginning at 7 o'clock. So 7 to 1 a.m. as Rick Renner says, to mayhem in the a.m. 6 hours of football coverage on your screen. So we'll see you there.
All right, Aaron Hartigan, thank you so much. The third quarter is about to begin. Thank you for being with us. This has been great. Appreciate it very much. We're VipeFortBend.com. The second half is next.
We see all you do to get work done, whether it's keeping your office clean or redesigning your space for $3 or $300. Our business is to keep business going. Buy online and pick up in store, or get free next business day shipping at Office Depot, Office Max, and OfficeDepot.com.
Welcome back. It's halftime on VipeFortBend.com, and our score is
17-6. Westfield over Hightower.
So we'll get going with a third quarter in a little while, but now it's time to talk to Bradley Stavenaugh. He is your local insurance agent, and we really appreciate you, Bradley, sponsoring these broadcasts for the Needville Insurance Agency. And tell us a little bit about yourself and why people should come to you.
Roger, I'm glad to be here. Glad to be out in the eastern half of Fort Bend County here today, enjoying these young professionals, these young athletes out here. Watching them, it's such a pleasure. I'm located down in South End of County, Needville, Texas, but we want to be your trusted agent. I'm a local guy. I've been here, and family's been here forever. We want to get to know you and get to know you, especially if you're recent arrivals and moved here to Fort Bend County. I would love to meet you. I try to get involved with the community quite a bit here in the area. I'm in the American Legion, the Rotary Club. I'm the chamber president in Needville. Do many activities. We cook with the Knights of Columbus Hall. Any event in Needville, you will see me there. I try to get on the east side as much as I can. I love Sugar Land. I love Missouri City. I love my friends here that have moved in here, and we hope you love living out here in this new area.
And I can say, personally, that you have saved me money on my car insurance already. And I know that there are a lot of folks out there, when you have teenage drivers, one or more of them in your family, especially, you know how risk management is. You got a teenage boy in your family. I know those insurance premiums can get high. What can you do to bring them down and bring down everyone's cost of living?
Well, we do the insurance shopping for you. We'll shop that insurance with many, several carriers that we deal with, and we make insurance easy for you. I know it's complicated. We know it's hard. A lot of words are frustrating to understand, but we make it where it's not difficult. We take all the frustration out of insurance.
Well, you know, there are things that people have a lot of choices. I know that sometimes there are these big national companies, and if you're watching TV, you'll see their commercials all the time. What is the advantage of coming to someone like you who has roots down right here in Fort Bend County for a long time?
Well, the book of business I personally sell for has been around since 1903. After the 1900 hurricane, it really not only devastated Galveston with over 6,000 people killed, it decimated Fort Bend County. That's why if you drive around the county, you don't see many buildings built before the Great Depression. There's not a whole lot left. With all the hurricanes we've had, it seems like one every 6 to 7 years, there's nothing much left. I am on the Fort Bend Historical Society, and we try to identify these buildings, and there's not too many left. A few in Richmond, Rosenberg, but not much. After that 1900 storm, you know, back then there was no GoFundMe on Facebook like it is now.
There wasn't?
No. So what happened there is people got together, and they helped their friends and families. They donated money. They helped them rebuild their barns, rebuild their homes. After that storm, a lot of the Czech immigrants came together, and also the German immigrants, and started an insurance company. I personally deal with RVUS out of Temple, Texas. And they started, it's like a farmer's co-op or co-op insurance. When you buy insurance from RVUS, you're a member of this. You're like a co-op, you're part owner of the insurance company. And we take our premiums, bring it together, and we try to keep our premiums down by being selectful on who we insure. Also, you know, we talk about the 1900 storm, the 1913 flood. Remember, we had 61 inches of rain in 1913. The Colorado, the San Bernard, and the Brazos River floodwaters all came together below what would be present-day I-10. Kind of comparison, the bad storm we had in April of 2016 was only 49 inches, and you see how much water was on that one. You know, we just had a freeze this summer. Wow, it was a few days, no power, no electricity. Well, that's nothing compared to 1951 freeze. For 5 days straight, it never got above 28 degrees. And plus, you had 2 inches of rain that made everything slick. There was mass livestock deaths. It's when we do these Fort Bend historical interviews, everybody remembers the 1951 freeze. And Carla in 1965, they remember that hurricane. It's the two big events that these people remember. Alvin, 1979, if everybody remembers, the record, 43 inches of rain within a 24-hour period. Who's to say that couldn't happen here again anywhere in Fort Bend County? Previous to that, Sweeney, Texas, just down the road from us too, or just down the road from Alvin, had 39 inches in one day. So no matter how high you are, you're going to get flooded with that many inches of rain. So be prepared. Buy flood insurance. Get your fire insurance. Come to an expert that knows Fort Bend County and knows the history of what's happened here. You know, we think of climate change. We think all these new storms that came in, the Tax Day flood, the Memorial Day flood. It's been even worse before. Looking back in history, there's been several major hurricanes, rainstorm events. We haven't seen the worst in the last 10 years. There's a lot of things that happened here in Fort Bend County on the Gulf Coast of Texas here.
We're talking with Bradley Stavanov of the Needville Insurance Agency, and we'll come back and, you know, he knows a lot about history. He knows a lot about some other things, and we'll be back on VipeFortBend.com.
It's that time of year where you hear people using the S word. September, that is. Occasionally, you can hear the great employees at First Tire and Automotive using another S-word with customers. Savings. Fall specials include 50% off an oil change. Now's the time to make sure your auto is ready to kick off the season in tip-top shape. Head to the website firsttireandauto.com and claim your savings. First Tire and Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vipe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugar Land and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. firsttireandauto.com.
Welcome back to Halftime as we continue with Bradley Stavanov of the Needville Insurance Agency. And he's a guy that can help you out because we're all trying to figure out how to make our bills get smaller, not bigger. So, Bradley, I know you've told us about where you're from, Needville, out here in the very nice rural part of Fort Bend County. But what if people say that they're from an urban neighborhood or suburban? Why should they go to the guy whose office is out in the country in Needville?
We know everybody's busy. We come to you. We can do everything through email, Twitter, or text. We get everything simplified, make it simple for you to do business with us. We don't make you come into our office. We can send the papers out for you to e-sign. We can do everything over the phone. Easy, easy, easy. That's the key. We want you to trust us, to be your trusted agent, and we want to take care of you and make everything simple and easy for you, because we know how busy you are.
And speaking of busy, think about what it takes when you're a parent, and you know all about this, when you want your kids to get the most out of their athletic career because they love the game that they play. And your daughters played volleyball for Needville. They played at the state championship level, and that's not cheap. So anything that people can do to save that money so that if they need to travel quite a bit for volleyball or whatever sport it might be, your company and the savings that you provide make that possible.
Oh, of course, we know y'all are involved in club teams, AAU, and you're traveling. You're going to tournaments everywhere. You're going to softball tournaments. You're going to volleyball tournaments. We know how busy you can be. We just want to make things easy, get you that quote out quickly. And once you do call us, we usually have that quote out within an hour to you. We don't mess around. We get the work done over here.
Well, I got to know you because of Needville back in 2018. Your Blue Jay ladies went to the state championship final against Decatur. Didn't come home with the trophy that year, but Needville has had some glorious years when they were number one.
Yes, and you know, the five championship titles, there has been a Stavanaugh on every team of those five different championship teams. My oldest daughter won the state title in 2017. They came back the next year, 2018, got runner-up in a heartbreaking loss. We still feel the pain on that one, but the girls got the rings. They're off at both of them at Texas A&M now, enjoying life. They still play volleyball. They still love the game. I went to the apartment here a couple weekends ago. We played sand volleyball there at the apartment, kicked everybody's butt over there with I got the inside scoop on. We should have been betting money on the games.
By the way, since the UIL won't let us do these ball games, if we say anything about gambling, we just got to strike that from the record, okay? But he said it, UIL. I did not. And so, also want to point out that the first time I ever saw Needville play volleyball was also the first time I ever saw Fulshear play volleyball. It was one of the greatest two-year rivalries in the history of high school sports. But now that Fulshear has moved up in classification and Needville's still in Class 4A, you could both win a state championship in the same year and maybe even be happy for each other, right?
I doubt we'd ever be happy for each other. That was a strong rivalry games. It got pretty loud in both gyms. Some heated tempers there, but I enjoyed those years, and I miss going to games. I still go to the games. My sister's the head coach at Needville, and I enjoy watching volleyball and high school football. I have a love. When I played in Needville, went to the state semifinals, played at Kyle Field, and that's something I'll never forget. High school sports are just something that brings teams together and just the greatest things in high school to me. So you learn so much. Leadership, how to work as a team. There's so many attributes you learn through playing high school sports.
We love it. We never get tired of it. That's why we do what we do at VibeFortBend.com. And I tell you what, like they said in the musical Seven Brides for Seven Brothers, next to loving, I like fighting. So that's why you talk about those rivalries, and when teams don't like each other, it's so much more interesting to watch them play when they do that. So Bradley Stavanaugh, thanks for being with us, and thanks so much for your great support this year.
All right. Thank you for having me today out here. Go Blue Jays.
And give your web address and your phone number one more time, the Needville Insurance Agency.
Easy web address, needvilleinsurance.com. Phone number 979-793-7411.
All right, we'll be back with more of the halftime. This is VibeFortBend.com.
Hi, this is Mariela.
And Melina, coming to you from Nick's Italian Restaurant, where you can come and try one of our house specialties, the Nick's Shrimp, or one of our chicken pistachios. Not in the mood for food? You can also try one of our savory desserts, like our homemade tiramisu or cannoli.
We're located on FM 1464, just north of Austin High School.
Can't dine in? You can call ahead at 346-401-1546 7 days a week from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Or you can hit us on one of the major delivery platforms, Uber, Grubhub, or DoorDash.
We look forward to seeing you here at Nick's Italian Restaurant, where our family gets bigger every time you stop by.
All right, everybody, the second half has begun. The Westfield Mustangs with the ball, second and five at their own 35-yard line. This is the second play from scrimmage in the second half, and they run it over the left side. Damir Scott, and he is hit, and the ball comes out, and it's recovered by Hightower. Forcing the fumble was number 33, Jeremy Strotter, and I think maybe Ephraim Dodson got it on the recovery, but the key was that Strotter knocked it loose. Okay, so it is 17-6, Westfield over Hightower. And because Westfield deferred when they won the toss to start the game, they got the ball first here in the third quarter, and they ran two plays and fumbled it away. Opportunity knocking for Hightower as they have it at the 46-yard line of Westfield. Patrick?
Well, that was a good gain on the run, but he got the ball knocked out of his hand. Opportunity for Hightower.
Out of the pistol. Penson hands it off to Payne. Going over the left side. Looking strong. Running that slant play. And he picks up 9 yards. He's brought down on the play by Dominic Bailey of Westfield. And that's good positive yardage on first down. A lot of things you can do on second and short. Payne, I'll bet your stats can tell us, but I'll bet Jeremy Payne is the leading rusher for Hightower in the game. I don't think he has huge numbers, though. They do give it to him again, but he is planted in the backfield, 3 yards back behind the line, and wow, what a game Anthony Holmes is playing.
Yeah, he's
that guy's a beast.
Starting off where he left off in the first half, and you mentioned Payne. Of course, he had the 30-yard touchdown run on the first drive of the game for Hightower, and since then, it's been a goose egg in terms of putting points on the board. Try to take advantage of a big turnover here early in the second half, but it's third and five.
So Penson needs to get the protection. His guys need to get open downfield. Takes the snap. Has time. Throws over the middle, and he should have had a completion there. Not his fault. It just went right between the elbows of Dylan Sublett, who was open near the 22-yard line.
It would have been a good catch. He had to go down for it, but like you said, it looked like it went right through the mitts, and he probably could have had it. They're going to have to punt here from the Westfield 40.
Yeah, they are. That's a shame. And if you are Caleb Douglas, you want to take something off of this one. Don't boot it through the end zone. You don't really help yourself that much. Hopefully he'll try to kick toward the sideline. Not too many punters seem to do that anymore.
No, I was going to mention that earlier. Here's a high snap. He's going to run it.
There he goes over the left side. And I think he got the stick. He got the first down inside the 35. They mark him at the 34. Yes, indeed, that is a first down. Think of First Tyrant Automotive for all your car care needs. Check them out at firsttyrantauto.com.
Well, Roger, was it the snap or did he have, was he going to do that anyway?
You know, that it is very hard for me to tell, but something tells me he was given the option to do so. And if he saw enough daylight, he should go for it. He did.
He sure saw the daylight. There was a lot of daylight out there, and he was able to get 1 yard beyond the sticks for the first down.
From the 34, first and 10, out of the pistol. Turn around, handoff to Payne, and he's hit near the line of scrimmage, but he's very determined, and he picks up 3 yards. And rolling over, getting up off the bottom of the pile was Westfield's Braylon Wyatt. By the way, Patrick, you will have the game between Dulles and Willow Ridge tomorrow from right here at Hall Stadium. And I guess we'll go on the air about 5:55 for a 6 o'clock kickoff.
Sounds good, Roger.
I'm looking forward to listening to you from Austin if I'm not too busy. I will be working there.
Yes.
And there's another handoff, and tough for Payne to get out of the backfield. He does get back to the line of scrimmage and maybe squeezes out a gain of a yard.
I think he went underneath the tackler that time. He kind of dipped down and was able to squirm for two.
Yeah, he did get two, and so it's third and six.
Because I think our man, who we've mentioned many times tonight already, Anthony Holmes, was in there, and I think he just did a limbo act underneath his outstretched arms.
By the way, doesn't Westfield's band sound great?
Absolutely.
They're not that big of a band, but man, what a big sound.
Yeah, they're coming across the field loud and clear.
Love those sounds. Third and six. Penson drops back. Late rush over the middle. Incomplete. Looking for Douglas, but two Westfield Mustangs were there. Brian Eshmond and Dominic Bailey made sure it wasn't a completion. And where they are on the field now, Patrick, don't you think that they just got to go for
it? Well, it's third and six. I don't think they have the same kind of kicker as Westfield has. And really, it's high school football. This is not a bad play here on fourth and six. If you don't get it, you still got them at their own 30. So,
yeah, you're too far for a field goal. You're too close to punt.
Yep.
Might as well go for it. Penson with 8:16 to go in the third, and his team down by 11 drops back. Now he is flushed to the right and throws late and got a completion at the 12. First down. Nice diving catch there. Caleb Douglas, he the man. It's been hard for him to get open tonight against this outstanding Westfield secondary. And, of course, the front four or the front seven or whatever you want to, you know, quantify it up front for Westfield. They have been putting pressure on the quarterback, Penson, all night, but he got a completion there.
That was a great pass. He was very patient. Now they're knocking on the door at the 11-yard line.
Yep, it is at the 11. Looked like the 12 when he made the catch. Penson steps up, clock running with 7:37 to go in the third. Hightower down 17-6, and Penson throwing a fade route looking for Douglas, and it's a leap, and it's incomplete, and it's very lucky for Hightower that was not an interception, because holding his ground in a brilliant way out there against Caleb Douglas, I believe it was Cy Johnson.
He really had great position. The ball was slightly underthrown, and the defender was able to get around, and he probably should have caught it. I don't know if Douglas might have got a mitt in there to get it away from him. Nonetheless, it's second and 10 from the 11.
It might have been Cameron Phoenix, too. His jersey is kind of wrinkled up in front.
Scrunched up, yep.
Out of the pistol, Payne behind Penson. Penson looks to the right. Now flushed, near the numbers, near the sideline, just throws it late.
Jeez.
And close to a grounding call, and he was absolutely bent, folded, and stapled and thrown out of bounds by Jaquiel Carr.
Well, yeah, I think, wasn't it, looked like, was it 16?
Well, I think it was a little bit of both. I think it was Carr and also Kalen Golston.
Yeah, he was... Yeah, I think he was double-teamed there, and he was able to flutter a pass out of bounds at least just to save the yardage and make it only third and 10 rather than third and close to 20.
Okay, Patrick, they're at the 11, so if they throw incomplete here, I think you do bring on the field goal unit.
Yep.
But before this play is run, it's a timeout, Hightower. We'll take it with them and be back on VibeFortBend.com.
Hello, fans. This is Bradley Stavenaugh with Needville Insurance. We know Fort Bend County. I'm a fourth-generation resident of Fort Bend. I'm your local, hometown, trusted agent. With over 30 carriers and 9 auto insurance carriers, we shop the insurance for you. We know insurance is hard. We know it's complicated. We make it easy for you. We have Spanish speakers here available for you. Call us at 979-793-7411 or needvilleinsurance.com. Once again, call us 979-793-7411.
We want to thank Bradley Stavenaugh, our good friend at the Needville Insurance Agency. And let me tell you something, Patrick, you know about this as well as I do. You got parents and grandparents out there with a granddaughter, grandson, or a son or a daughter. They're driving the car, and you want to find the best value you can for your car insurance. And you also got people in your family who are not yet driving age but will be soon, and you got to find a way to manage that expense in your life. Go to Bradley Stavenaugh, Needville Insurance Agency. He can help you save money. It's not the offer in your mailbox that's the best.
Penson drops back on third and 10. And he steps up and he scrambles. He gets good yardage inside the five and dives to the two. Oh, he's so close to the first down. It depends on where he spots it. They might have a first and goal at the two.
Well,
but
like you said,
I think they.
It's
well,
the spot that matters, and I think they're a little short.
Oh, I don't know.
They got a fourth down.
They need to measure this. Patrick, look at that. It's right on what they need. They should measure it, but it's a sneak, and Penson goes forward.
He's got to be in.
And not only does he have a first down, I'm sure he's got that. They unpile, and it's a touchdown. Hightower. The Hurricanes are on the board. And do you go for two here? This makes it 17-12. You might want to go ahead and go for two.
Looks like I think they're going to do it. They're bringing in some beef for blocking, it looks like.
Oh, yeah, the what I like to call the bull-elephant backfield. By the way, thank you, Trey Grubb, doing a great job as monitoring the broadcast quality. And one of the guys they brought in, Jaden Deemer, he's a 6'5 tight end, you know, with somebody 6'5. If he can break through the line, you just kind of throw it up there where only he can get it. That might be good.
Well, he's in position to possibly go for a pass. Now they have a delay of game, Roger, on the two-point conversion.
Okay, so
that might take the running play out of possibility
here. How did they let that happen?
I'm not sure. I think they were, you know, trying to get different personnel in the ball game, and meanwhile, the play clock is winding down, and sometimes you lose track. And so here they are now from the 8-yard line trying to get the 2-point play.
All right. So they do maintain more personnel in the backfield here and only one wideout. It's Caleb Douglas, and they're throwing that way in the corner, and the pass is tipped away incomplete. Very strong, thorough double coverage in the corner, and the two-point try is no good. Nevertheless, Hightower does get back to within 5 points. It's 17-12 with 6:54 to go in the third.
Every day, someone comes up to me and says, Amy, how amazing is Xfinity Internet? And I always say, guys, I could go on and on about how it gives you more than just fast speeds for all your work, school, and everything from home needs, but I have places to be. I'd also mention you can save up to $400 a year on wireless when you add Xfinity Mobile and get nationwide 5G at no extra cost. But I gotta run. I have a thing. Really, it happens all the time. Can your internet do that?
Get started with Xfinity Internet for $19.99 a month for 12 months with a one-year agreement. Plus, save up to $400 a year on wireless over AT&T when you add Xfinity Mobile. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay. Ends 10-18-21. Restrictions apply. New Performance Starter Plus Internet customers only. Equipment, taxes and fees extra, and subject to change. After term, regular rates apply. Savings based on optimized pricing. Xfinity Internet required.
Archer Volkswagen Showroom is open, and our team's excited to help you. Visit our sales department Monday through Saturday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Or bring your car in for service from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Friday, and Saturdays from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. We're closed on Sundays to rest and recharge with our families, so we can serve you well through the week. We hope to see you soon.
After the Hightower touchdown and the failed two-point conversion, Westfield gets a pretty decent run back on the kickoff. It was DeQuarius Calhoun, and he went out of bounds just short of his own 40-yard line. First and 10 from the 39 for Westfield. That, you know, Patrick, it feels like the Mustangs have been dominating this game, and yet they're only up by five. Hightower very much in this game.
That's a really good point. That fumble, and then Hightower takes advantage and scores the touchdown. 5-point game.
Cardell Williams has been very impressive at quarterback for Westfield. He drops back, throws out in the left flat, and gets a completion. One tackle broken across midfield. Goes Xavier Todd, and he's got a first down after a 13-yard gain for the Westfield Mustangs. That moves the sticks. It's a first down. Think of First Tire and Automotive for all your car care needs. Check them out at firsttireandauto.com.
And a whistle prior to the snap as they were about to get it going on first and 10 from the Hightower 48. I think this will be a timeout, actually, called by Hightower. Is this their second timeout call?
Second timeout of the half. It might come to back to haunt them later. They had too many men on the field, and Westfield got up to the line of scrimmage and ready to run that play. One guy running off the field, and they had to call timeout to save the penalty yardage. Roger, right. Have you ever thought about sometimes you wonder if it's just better to take the penalty and save the timeout sometimes in these situations?
Yeah, sometimes it's kind of like in basketball when you will see a guy, he leaps over the boundary while in the air, grabs the ball, and rather than throw it back in, rather than save it, he will call a timeout before his feet hit the floor. I used to see that a lot more in college and professional basketball.
Yeah.
And it seems silly to waste a timeout when, let's say, there's 8 minutes left in the game.
Yeah.
You're saving a possession, and it, you know, a possession saved is good, but timeouts are valuable too.
Exactly. We'll see. First and 10, 48-yard line.
Williams fakes the handoff, runs around the left side, gets outside the numbers, and picks up a gain of 3, and he's slung down like a wet rag by Julian Payne.
He had a lead blocker that time. His number here, it's Smith, Rodney Smith. He faked the handoff to him, and he just followed Rodney Smith to the left side, but only to get 3 yards.
On second down and 7, now Williams looks right, pump short, now throws way down the far sideline into double coverage, and the ball is tipped and incomplete. He was trying to get it to DeJohn Palomo, and it's just a harmless incomplete pass, and way, way out there on the, you know, the places where it gets a little bit dark,
yeah,
near the sideline.
It's hard to tell these numbers.
It really is hard. Silver on Forest Green right now, so sorry we couldn't identify the defenders.
That pass was a bit forced. Great coverage by Hightower. Not much of a chance to get that one in there. 3rd and 7 now. Big play.
Calculated risk. You know, if it had been intercepted, it wouldn't have done them that much harm. There is a screen pass, and it is incomplete and nearly picked by Kaishun Smith of the Hightower Hurricanes, and the defense does a great job. By the way, Patrick, you and some friends and I have dined at Nick's Italian Restaurant in Sugar Land, and it's
yes.
like family there, isn't it?
Yes, it's wonderful.
You know, and as a matter of fact, you'd say that their family gets bigger every time you stop by at Nick's Italian Restaurant on 1464, just north of Austin High School in Sugar Land. But the family connection is Jeremy Payne and Julian Payne of the Hightower Hurricanes. And remember, go to Nick's Italian Restaurant because their family gets bigger every time you stop by. And on 4th and 7, it is going to be their kicking specialist, Jonathan Dimas, who punts it, and the ball is going to roll dead inside the 5. Oh, my goodness. Inside the 1 at the half-yard line. What a brilliant punt. Now, officially, that punt is 44 yards, but you and I know it's 44 and a half yards. Brilliantly done by Dimas. He can not only bomb the football on kickoffs, field goals, and conversion kicks, but he can also kind of, I bet he's a golfer.
Yeah, I wonder.
He can kind of lay it up
and
there.
And you notice he's a sophomore, for crying out loud.
Yes,
I just
is.
Noticed. And I just can't imagine he's already got people scouting him to get him to be kicking over in their programs. He is a good-looking kicker. And a good job of feeling the ball downfield by his teammates to down at the 1, and Hightower is in the...
You know, every player, Patrick, has their feet in the end zone.
That's exactly right.
Even the center has his feet in the end zone here.
You almost wonder if they should quarterback sneak it, but he's in a shotgun snap situation.
Oh, and you got to make sure you don't commit a penalty on offense inside your end zone, because that would be a safety. 5:30 to go in the 3rd. Hightower down by 5, but they're 99 and a half yards away
from
the goal
boy.
Line.
That's
and
a
they
safety.
Were buried on a running play, but they pushed the pile beyond the goal line, and You said it's a safety. If they had called the ball dead,
oh boy,
when you said that, it would have been. But somehow
he got out of there. I thought he was going to be first. It was going to be called a safety. I can't imagine that ball is more than an inch off the line there.
You know what? I think we're going to have one of those situations where three-quarters of the ball can be in the end zone, and they will turn it around. They will put the back end of the ball where the nose of the ball was, because I think by rule you can't actually have the ball in the end zone. But Payne, somewhere in that mass of humanity, kept pushing forward, and his big guys kept pushing forward as well, and somehow they avoided the safety.
As far away from your own, from your touchdown as you could possibly be.
They're going to try to throw it. Penson looking down there, and the pass is picked by Westfield. No, it comes out of the hands. Oh, my goodness. DeQuarius Calhoun had him a pick at the 22, and when he hit the ground, it came out, and it was kind of like, what would you say? it's one of those.
Where you drop it when it hits the ground?
What do they call that rule? The special rule where you got to complete the catch.
Oh, yeah, you got to complete the catch. Exactly. He definitely had the ball. The ground, just he couldn't hang on to it. Now it's third and 11 from the inch line. Hightower dodged a bullet
wrong,
there.
Patrick. I think it's the centimeter line.
Yeah.
I think it's that
close. What do we got here?
Oh, my goodness.
How can it go any further back?
Well, it's going to be a pre-snap penalty of some kind. I think it might be a substitution infraction. Let's listen.
It was a substitution
infraction against Hightower. I saw one of their tight ends, Jaden Deemer, coming off the field, and he was gesturing as if, I can't be the only guy coming off. We got too many men.
Yep.
Well, that was pre-snap, so it's not a safety, but it's third and 10. Be careful back there. Mr. Penson takes the snap, drops back, throws over the middle, and it's incomplete. Threw it behind his receiver. He was under heavy pressure as he tried to get it to Jaden Adams, and it's going to be time to punt. Patrick, we've been watching all night. When Hightower punts, the snap usually looks like it has helium in it.
Yeah.
It doesn't get back there very fast.
This is tough because you don't have your full distance to drop back and punt, because normally you drop back maybe close to 14, 15 yards. And
yes, if you don't mind me mixing measuring systems, it's 10 yards plus 1 centimeter. And Caleb Douglas can't let his heel step on the end line. And he's just got to get it out of there quick as he can, and he does. Good job. And it wobbles down to the 32-yard line, and there is a nice move and straight up the middle of the field with a return of about 9 yards. It's Calhoun, and so Hightower, well, they couldn't move it on offense, and Westfield now takes over with a very short field, 4:18 to go in quarter number three.
I don't want to harp on it too much, but the punter for Westfield could take some credit for this field position after that. I guess it was a 44-yard punt that got him down to the one, and then the Westfield defense did its job and held him, and now look at where Westfield is, 23-yard line to start the drive.
And Cardell Williams, you can tell he's the boss out there, has Atkins behind him, turns around and hands it off to Atkins, and goes around the right edge, tripped near the 20, but keeps on moving inside the 10, fighting at the 4. There's a big scrum of people that keeps moving toward the goal line. Look out. He came up short, but he got all the way down to either the 1 or the 2.
Wow, that was a great run. And then, as you said, his linemen saw that he was close, and they were trying to do the rugby scrum into the end zone, but then he was knocked out of bounds. But it's first and goal from the 3 for Westfield.
And I like to see Delrick Williams. He's the left guard, and he pulled on the play, moved to his right, and I don't know how many people he knocked down.
Yeah.
But he came back to the huddle clapping his hands together. He likes to move guys from point A to point B against their will.
And he
Atkins
sure did.
Atkins in the pistol. Is behind Williams, turns around and gives it to Atkins. This time running to the left side, and I think he might have lost a yard as Hightower got very strong penetration. Run support from Thaddeus Guidry, and it is indeed a loss of one. It's second and goal from the 4.
Well, if you can hold them to three here, you could stay within the one possession situation. But it's going to be a tall order from the four-yard line.
Maybe Westfield could do him a favor and commit a penalty. Fake to Atkins, bootleg right. Williams throwing near the goal line.
Oh,
caught and down to the one. Good tackle there. It is Chucky Hines, and we found out during halftime that's how he pronounces his name. I didn't see who got the tackle, but someone jumped on his back right after he caught it, stopped his momentum. And as we pass the three-minute mark in the third quarter, it's third and goal at the one. This is the biggest play of the game so far. On the right hash mark as Westfield moves right to left here in the third quarter, leading by five. And there is a delay play, and there goes Atkins off the right side into the end zone. Touchdown, no flags, and Westfield extends its lead to two scores yet again.
Well, it was only 1 yard to go. Quick shotgun snap, handoff. Atkins had a nice hole, and it was a good touchdown for Westfield. 23-yard drive. And here's the man who helped set it up, the kicker.
I'm going to remember the last name Demas, Jonathan Demas.
Yeah.
He is a sophomore with a very strong right leg. He was waiting for his holder, who now arrives. That's Xavier Todd.
Delay of game.
And delay of game, and that's too bad that they didn't snap it a little sooner because it went skittering back, and I think that somehow, you know, Hightower might have been able to squash that conversion attempt and keep it at an 11-point game.
Which matters because 11 points is you can still score with a touchdown, a two-point play, and a field goal. If it's 12, it's a different ball game.
Demas back to the 15-yard line, what would be the equivalent of a 25-yard field goal attempt. And no doubt about it, we can tell from here from where it landed, right down the middle. That guy is, he kicks like a pro already. All right, 24-12, 2:39 to go in the third. We shall return on BikeFortBend.com.
Archer Volkswagen Showroom is open, and our team's excited to help you. Visit our sales department Monday through Saturday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Or bring your car in for service from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Friday, and Saturdays from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. We're closed on Sundays to rest and recharge with our families, so we can serve you well through the week. We hope to see you soon.
Hi, this is Mariela.
And Melina, coming to you from Nick's Italian Restaurant, where you can come and try one of our house specialties, the Nick's Shrimp, or one of our chicken pistachios. Not in the mood for food? You can also try one of our savory desserts, like our homemade tiramisu or cannoli.
We're located on FM 1464, just north of Austin High School.
Can't dine in? You can call ahead at 346-401-1546 7 days a week from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Or you can hit us on one of the major delivery platforms, Uber, Grubhub, or DoorDash.
We look forward to seeing you here at Nick's Italian Restaurant, where our family gets bigger every time you stop by.
Demas bombs a 3-iron out of the back of the end zone, and Hightower will take over at their 25-yard line, trailing by 12, 24-12, with 2:37 left in this third quarter. And how about a few scores here, Patrick?
All right, I know you got it queued up.
Well, out of Lamar Consolidated ISD, the flagship school of that district, the Lamar Consolidated Mustangs trailing the Terry Rangers 10-7 going into the fourth quarter. It is the Alief Taylor Lions and the Angleton Wildcats tied up at 21 all at halftime. This is of concern to spring people, but hold on. Here we go, first and 10. Penson drops back. Here comes the rush, gets it away. Incomplete on the screen attempt. Had to get it to Jeremy Payne. If he hadn't gotten rid of it quickly, Anthony Holmes would have planted him into the ground. Okay, so down in spring, you have DeCaney High School, so the Westfield people know DeCaney, and DeCaney is getting trounced. Summer Creek 45 and DeCaney 7 just in the third quarter. They're about 2 minutes into the third quarter. North Shore, 34-7 over Klein Collins. Less than 9 minutes to go in that one. 2.5 minutes to go in the third quarter here. Penson drops back, looking, and he's going to airmail it. And he underthrew his man, incomplete, just inside Westfield territory as he tried to deliver it to Zion Kearney, who's been held without a catch this week after scoring on a 96-yard touchdown last week. Things have gotten a little bit quiet here, Patrick, because I guess the band is getting a little bit of a break.
Well, that's what I was, you mentioned the Westfield band. I was watching them just periodically, and they just look like they're having a good time over there. They got movements with the beat and all that, and they look like they're having a great time.
It's great when you have a band director who facilitates fun.
Yep, absolutely.
Third down and 10. And a whistle prior to the snap. What's going on?
Looks like a delay of game.
Maybe. Yeah, that's what it is.
Those are tough because it's, what do you call that, an unforced error?
Unforced. They had plenty of time. The Pearland Oilers, 14-3 ahead of Memorial going to the fourth quarter. Pearland got trounced by Ridgepoint last week, but they bounced back nicely. Penson on third and 15. Can't find anyone, runs up the middle, gets a little bit of yardage, but not nearly enough. Advances it to the 18, and guess who made the tackle? Anthony Holmes.
How many tackles do you think he's got today? It would be interesting to have kept track of that. He's double figures for sure.
I'm
huh?
sure. I'm Jeez, sure, yes. I'm not very good at kind of keeping that in my head.
He has been in on multiple plays, including a couple of sacks. And then if he's not sacking him, he's putting pressure on him.
So that was a gain of 2.5. And so on fourth and 12.5, there's another high snap. Douglas has it, gets the punt away. It flutters, goes across midfield and bounces out of bounds at the 45-yard line of Westfield, where the Mustangs, leading 24-12, will take over. 1:39 to go in the third, and how about another score or two? Langham Creek is leading Jersey Village 28-24 in the first minute of the fourth quarter. Waller beating up on Aldine 62-0. 4:08 to go.
How big of a school is Waller?
Waller, I believe, is a 5A.
Wow, I didn't know they were that big.
I may be mistaken. They could be a 4A. Eisenhower leading Channelview 48-14. 3 minutes to go in the third. And Westfield, empty backfield for Williams, who drops back, throws a little jailbreak screen, and that's going to go for over 10 yards. It'll be another first down to the high tower 40 as he delivered the ball to Chucky Hines. Mark it at the 41 of Hightower, and that is a first down. Think of First Tire and Automotive for all your car care needs. Check them out at firsttireandauto.com. And Williams throwing again, but out of bounds, beyond the reach of his intended receiver, Kelby Thomas Haymond. All right, maybe a score or two more. Here's a good one. Clear Springs on the way to an upset, leading 43-33 over number 12 ranked Tompkins with 9 minutes to go in that one. Man, I'm so glad this High School Scoreboard Live app is back. Over the middle, late, Williams throws, and it's off the hands of an intended receiver, Cathcart, who was complaining that he was interfered with by Braylon Kazee of Hightower, but no flag, so it'll be third and 10. Texas City leading Galveston Ball, 26-7, going to the fourth period, and this is ugly. Alvin leading Kempner 17-0 with 6 minutes to go in the third. Kempner maybe having a hard time. I'm not sure if their starting quarterback Evers from last week is able to play this week. Third and 10, Williams flush to the right, looking way down the field, far sideline, too far for anyone to catch up to. He threw it all the way from about the 45 to about halfway deep in the end zone on the run. Yep. So that stops the clock, 1:02 to go in the third.
It's easy to see from up here, but he, I think, could have gotten the first down if he'd have just run the ball, and he threw into double coverage again, there was not much of a chance for a completion. Here comes the punter, Jonathan. Is it
Demas?
Demas. He's our man who's been having a heck of a game as a kicker.
Well, he's still just a boy, but man, he kicks like a man.
Look at that!
I'll tell
kick.
You what, that is a high hanging punt. He didn't really want distance; he just wanted hang time, and it's very effective as he has a teammate able to down it at the 10-yard line.
And he took that ball off the ground. The snap was low, and he's able to come up with it and then get a really high kick. No chance for a return because the defenders were down there hovering. He got him down at the 10-yard line.
I would go beyond hovering, Patrick, and say lurking. They were lurking.
There you go. Okay. You want to be a little more specific here.
Well, I love words. They fascinate me. You can change your meaning, and the people who are listening to you can change your meaning to nothing close to what you intended. We all know how painful that can be.
Yeah.
Look at this. Last minute of the third. Gosh. Here comes Holmes, but getting it away and getting a completion on the screen pass and a gain of about 8 yards. And that was Jeremy Payne receiving it from Penson, who is getting some good trial by fire here of getting off an accurate pass quickly when you've got someone about to
a great play because
knock you into next week.
Yeah, Holmes was just about to tattoo him, and he's able to get the ball off quick.
20 seconds left in the third quarter, and the clock still ticking down. Now it's down to 15. Penson in the pistol, takes the snap, turns around, hands it to Payne, pops through, good gain, first down. First down at the 28-yard line. He keeps on running like he did on his touchdown earlier, but the whistles are blowing and his knee did hit the ground. And I think that'll be the last play of the third.
Looks like
they'll reset the chains, 3 seconds will expire, and then we will move on to the fourth period. All right, let's go ahead and step away. We know that's what's going to happen. Roger Smith and Patrick Kinnick after three. It is 24-12, Westfield over Hightower.
Every day someone comes up to me and says, Amy, how amazing is Xfinity Internet? And I always say, guys, I could go on and on about how it gives you more than just fast speeds for all your work, school, and everything from home needs, but I have places to be. I'd also mention you can save up to $400 a year on wireless when you add Xfinity Mobile and get nationwide 5G at no extra cost. But I gotta run. I have a thing. Really, it happens all the time. Can your internet do that?
Get started with Xfinity Internet for $19.99 a month for 12 months with a one-year agreement. Plus, save up to $400 a year on wireless over AT&T when you add Xfinity Mobile. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and autopay. Ends 10/18/21. Restrictions apply. New Performance Starter Plus Internet customers only. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra and subject to change. After term, regular rates apply. Savings based on optimized pricing. Xfinity Internet required.
It's that time of year where you hear people using the S word. September, that is. Occasionally, you can hear the great employees at First Tire and Automotive using another S word with customers. Savings. Fall specials include 50% off an oil change. Now's the time to make sure your auto is ready to kick off the season in tip-top shape. Head to the website firsttireandauto.com and claim your savings. First Tire and Automotive, a proud sponsor of Fort Bend Vibe Sports. Make your appointment today at any of the four convenient locations in Sugar Land and Cinco Ranch. All four stores open on Saturday. firsttireandauto.com.
First play of the fourth quarter, Hightower running it to the left and not much there. It was Penson just trying to get through all those big Westfield bodies. Not easy to do.
Another player that's been pretty active, we haven't mentioned him a whole lot, but Ray Jones, big number 95, was part of that tackle. And again, Holmes had a jersey early to slow him down for no gain.
I also saw Brian Eichmond getting a part of the tackle. Second down and 10 for Hightower. Penson drops back. Here comes the rush. Steps up. He's hit by Holmes but escapes. Now he keeps going and fights back nearly to the line of scrimmage. That may go down as a sack, as finally finishing him off, Christopher Walker not Christopher Walken, because as you see, it was very close to being a sack on that play. By the way, very underrated movie, Patrick. Did you ever see Mouse Hunt?
No.
Oh, Mouse Hunt is very, very funny. I know what age your kids are, and you can watch it with them. There are a few things that are maybe a little PG-13-ish, but it's just outstanding. Nathan Lane is in it, and Christopher Walken. On third down and 10, draw a play and blown up. Holmes just absolutely destroying Andreas Missik-Duncombe.
Wow.
Ow. That hurt from up here.
Right. That was, well, somebody over there on the right side of the Hightower line, you kind of feel sorry for. They're just having a hard time blocking Holmes. That time he came like a missile.
He de-cleated him, and it was a two-yard loss, so it'll be fourth and 12. But back to Mouse Hunt.
Yes.
Christopher Walken is only in the movie for about 10 minutes, but he steals the show. Oh, it's funny. Mouse Hunt.
I hate to say it, admit this, but I don't really know who that Christopher Walken is.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
believe it.
Sorry to admit that.
So the punt is a short one, and this will be a big return. It is Calhoun, near sideline. He's got something. He's got a touchdown.
Well, he had a wide open alley on the right side. They had return right on, and they had the seal blocks, and he was gone. And
they got a seal there and a seal
there,
and he ran the football in the alley.
And then number 30. Help me with the last name here. Number 30 for Westfield.
Kimond Emelian.
Emelian did a wonderful job of blocking the last five yards.
All right, we know Demas is going to make the extra point. So let me ask you this. Did you ever see Balls of Fury, the movie about ping pong?
I have not seen
it. You should see that, because Christopher Walken's great line from that movie was, "What part of sudden death did you not understand?"
Well,
and the kick is good. Okay.
No news there.
All right. Our new score is 31 to 12, Westfield over Hightower. And we'll be back with more Christopher Walken lines when we continue on VipeFortBend.com.
Hello, fans. This is Bradley Stavenaugh with Needville Insurance. We know Fort Bend County. I'm a fourth generation resident of Fort Bend. I'm your local, hometown, trusted agent. With over 30 carriers and 9 auto insurance carriers, we shop the insurance for you. We know insurance is hard. We know it's complicated. We make it easy for you. We have Spanish speakers here available for you. Call us at 979-793-7411 or needvilleinsurance.com. Once again, call us 979-793-7411.
Hi, this is Mariela.
And Melina, coming to you from Nick's Italian Restaurant, where you can come and try one of our house specialties, the Nick's Shrimp, or one of our chicken pistachios. Not in the mood for food? You can also try one of our savory desserts, like our homemade tiramisu or cannoli.
We're located on FM 1464, just north of Austin High School.
Can't dine in? You can call ahead at 346-401-1546 7 days a week from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Or you can hit us on one of the major delivery platforms, Uber, Grubhub, or DoorDash.
We look forward to seeing you here at Nick's Italian Restaurant, where our family gets bigger every time you stop by.
Demas just bombed another one through the end zone. So Hightower now trailing 31 to 12. A very tall mountain to climb indeed.
Let's find out how much you really know, Roger.
Okay. I'm probably not going to know much.
I had to look it up.
Wait a minute. Before you ask a question, I know certain things about the few movies that I really like.
Okay.
I may not know, but go
ahead.
But
you're going to be able to at least produce a pretty good guess here.
Let's wait till after the first play. Yeah, Penson is in the pistol formation, and they bring in a guy to kind of provide a little extra protection, Elijah Jones, who's a tight end, but he's right behind the left guard. And Penson fakes it to the left and runs the bootleg to the right, throws near the sideline, and got a completion to guess who? It was Elijah Jones, who came out of the backfield. Now your question.
Well, before we say that, I noticed that Part of the reason why he had a little time there is our man's not in the ball game. Number 10, Holmes.
Oh, okay, I just noticed something else. Evidently, the pass was not complete.
Okay.
I don't know if Jones didn't firmly possess the ball before he reached the sideline or what, but it's second and 10.
Okay,
what you
so
got?
Anyway, well, I was able to – I said I didn't know who Christopher Walken was, but now that I've seen his picture, I know who he is. I just didn't realize that was his name. Second down and 10.
Penson in the pistol. Blitz look by Westfield and a give to Payne off the left side. He's got 5 yards and keeps on going. Gets three more. It's an 8-yard pickup as he's wrestled down. Lamond Wiley made sure he didn't go farther, but he did reach that area between the numbers and the sideline, and it's third down and 2.
Okay, how old is Christopher Walken? That's
I'm going
my question.
To guess that Christopher Walken must be at least 75 years old.
You are pretty darn close. He's 78.
Okay.
78 years old.
You wear it well, my friend.
That's correct.
Okay, third down, and they gave him a really good spot, actually. So it's not third and 2. It's third and 1. Can they convert against this big physical defensive front of Westfield? Up the middle they go. First down. Payne picks it up. That'll move the sticks. It's a first down. Think of First Tire and Automotive. For all your car care needs, check them out at firsttireandauto.com. A new set of downs at the 39-yard line for the Canes.
Let's give credit here. That, I believe, was Rankins who ran that ball, number 28.
Okay, well, that makes sense because he did look a little bit bigger and beefier than Jeremy Payne.
He got about 5 yards, 6 yards on that play.
Out of the pistol on first and 10, they give it to Hankins again. And, yes, he does run heavy, and he picks up 6. To his team's 45, it'll be second and 4.
Did I say Rankins?
I don't know.
It is Hankins.
It's yes. Frederick Hankins.
Yeah, I.
Did I say Hankins?
No, I did. No, you had it right. I had the R there, and I need my glasses, and I apologize to Frederick. He's running hard here. He's got some pretty positive gains here.
Under 8 minutes to go in the game. Penson hands it off. There goes Hankins. Makes a nice little move across the 50 into Westfield territory to the 48-yard line. He exceeds the need by 3 yards. That's a first down. Think of First Tire and Automotive for all your car care needs. Check them out at firsttireandauto.com.
Great running. He's got some powerful legs there, Mr. Hankins. And what is he? Looks like he's a senior, 220-pounder.
By the way, I guess we're done with all the walk-in questions.
Well, I don't even know what else. Well, I'll ask one more question.
Oh, just one more.
I know you
make it a good one.
Okay. Well, I know you.
There
kidding.
Goes Hankins up the middle, and he gets inside the 45 to the 44. And it's a big deficit here for Hightower, but effective running by Hankins on these last three plays. That's 4, and it's 2nd and 6.
Yeah, it's the Hankins show here, right in this drive. They're just deciding to give him some carries, and now he's coming off for a break. All right, well, so what would be the signature movie or show that he was part of?
Well, he was in a movie called True Romance in 1991.
Man. I don't know.
I can't remember the name of that director who made that film. Scorsese, I think, maybe it was.
Oh, nice.
And there is a give up the middle and almost a loss of yards in the backfield. Let's see. That was DeCambron Verrett or maybe Brendan Eaglin, actually. Brendan Eaglin, who had to make a very nice little spin move deep in the backfield, and he still didn't get back to the line. It's a loss of 1. So 3rd and 7 from the 45, and the clock is down to 6:15 and still ticking.
That's interesting. They've been running the ball here this whole series. I guess just to get the feeling of being a strong running team?
It was not Scorsese. It was Quentin Tarantino who directed True Romance. All right, Penson steps up in the pocket, flag down, throws far sideline, too tall for his receiver. Good coverage out there by Westfield's Cy Johnson. We'll check the flag.
I thought you were mentioning a player on the field, but you were
Quentin Tarantino.
You were talking about the producer of the show or the director.
Yeah, the film director. But anyway, I'll tell you
what
about
what number does he wear? Tarantino.
I will.
Oh my goodness!
Someday when we're not on the air, I'll tell you about True Romance and.
Well, you know, what are you going to give me some advice about True Romance?
There are just some scenes in it that
just very well done scenes, and you know, there's is a very violent film, a little too violent for me, but there's so many good parts of it that you know, one, if we're driving to the state championship game,
okay,
we'll talk about True
yeah,
Romance.
We'll have plenty of time there, yeah.
Out of the pistol, Penson fakes the handoff,
trying
to get away from trouble, and he is just snowed under. Was that Holmes again, or are they giving Holmes the rest of the night off?
He's in
there. Was in the middle of it.
Yeah. He is. Boy, I tell you what, you have a guy like that on your defense, you can put some things around that because, boy, he's been disruptive all night.
Well, Holmes is playing so well that let's just look into the future. Let's say Ridgepoint, off their 2-0 start, let's say they look very strong, go into the playoffs as the top seed and get at least as far as they did last year.
Yep.
Well, the good news is Westfield plays in Region 2. Ridgepoint is not going to have to meet the Westfield Mustangs. I don't think they will meet at all unless they both reached the championship game, if I'm not mistaken.
The championship of the state?
Of the state, yes, because I believe the champion from Region 1 plays the champion from Region 2. And the champion from Region 3, which is where the Fort Bend teams are, would play the champion from Region 4.
I'm going to just ask you this question. You have not seen Ridgepoint. We just know.
Oh, I saw him last night.
Oh, you did? Yeah, that's right. You
and
saw him last night.
They did not play a perfect game, but they you see the potential.
Are they
also had a couple of guys leave the field with an injury. If those guys are going to be okay, it'll be huge. But
let me ask you this after this play here.
Okay. Williams turns around and hands it off to Atkins, reading his blockers very nicely, and he gains 7 yards over the right side. And one of the Hightower Hurricanes, who kind of submarined him, got a little worse for wear as Jeremy Strotter kind of went underneath the tackler, and you can take a strong knee to the shoulder or the head or
he's
whatever.
He's walking around, though.
He's going to stay in there. Okay, go ahead. I'm not giving you enough time to talk.
The question was, okay, now you've seen both Ridgepoint and Westfield. After this play, give us your analysis of both teams, a little quick analysis.
On second down and 3, over the left side, they give it to Damir Scott, who breaks through and stumbles down right before he reaches the 20. Somebody made a little ankle tackle on him, and if not for that, he would have gone the distance.
Yeah, he was on his way, and that little bit of a shoelace tackle tripped him up, and he got to the 20. And anyway, what do you think about Westfield in comparison?
Well, Westfield, 31-12, they lead it, and they have the ball on the Hightower 20-yard line with under 5 minutes to go. I'd say that Westfield looks stronger than Ridgepoint right now. But it's week 2, okay?
Yeah.
Just remember that.
Yeah.
Slant play off the left side. Good run. And almost down to the pylon. It's Rodney Smith. Rodney Smith is a senior running back, and I'm sure he practices very hard. I'm glad to see him get some carries. But not so glad to see Westfield with a first and goal at the Hightower 4.
Yeah, they're just,
which is what they have.
They're gouging them now. They just kind of doing what they want at will here. Notice the Westfield offensive line. They are a big group as well. We hadn't mentioned much about them today, but, boy, they're stout.
High snap, and Williams going to run around the left side and into the end zone he goes. That's a touchdown if it stands. I don't see any flags, so that is a touchdown. 4-yard run for Cardell Williams, who looks like a real field general out there.
Yeah, I've been impressed with him. The only drawback I've seen from him, and this is maybe being a little bit too picky, but he's thrown the ball into double coverage a couple times or tried to force the play, a long pass play. But other than that, he has really looked good running the ball and passing.
Speaking of looking good, Demas kicking, kick up, good.
Oh, we only got it to the third lane of the track that time.
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah. you're a cruel man.
That's right.
But fair. Okay, 4:26 to go, and it's 38-12. The competitive part of this game is over, but Hightower will fight back and try to get a little bit something extra when we return on VipeFortBend.com.
Oh.
Archer Volkswagen Showroom is open, and our team's excited to help you. Visit our sales department Monday through Saturday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Or bring your car in for service from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Friday, and Saturdays from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. We're closed on Sundays to rest and recharge with our families, so we can serve you well through the week. We hope to see you soon. You are. Everything. We take care of you so you can take care of business. Office Depot, Office Max. Taking care of business.
This just in, Demas didn't kick the ball to the end zone. He kicked it to the one-yard line in a spectacular return by, was that Santana Wilson number three, or was it Caleb Johnson number one?
I believe it was number three.
Okay, number three, Santana Wilson. He started up the field, got to about the 15, and then realized he saw a team portrait of Westfield, a bunch of white jerseys right in front of him. So he reversed field and kind of bent it over to his right side and ran out of bounds, and a great amount of effort. By the way, there was a flag on the play.
Holding. Reversing the field may have helped produce that penalty. Demas kicked it only to the one, as you mentioned, but it was a high kick. And you almost get the sense that the coaches said, all right, now kick it so we can cover this one and get some practice in. They haven't done anything as far as, hey, I'm on the kickoff team. Do you do anything? No, well, I run to the goal line every play after the ball's been kicked out of the end zone.
Have you ever played pool where someone who's really good at lagging?
Yes.
Very gently tap the ball and make it go to the cushion but stop short?
Yeah.
Well, there you go. There's a run up the middle to the 10-yard line, a pickup of three. Who'd they give it to there? Probably someone who has labored and toiled in practice and would like to get the football more often. That's Brendan Eaglin.
He's
practicing for the Rockettes out there or something.
Doing a little high step coming out of there. Just not sure what that's all about. But anyway, three, four-yard pickup on the play. And clock running. As Roger said, it's not much doubt the result of this game right now.
On second down from the 10, Penson hands off, and there's a first down run, or very close to it, by Eaglin as he moves ahead to the 16. They move the sticks. It is a first down. Think of First Tyrant Automotive for all your car care needs. Check them out at firsttyrantauto.com.
Okay, Roger, it's 38-12. Do you recall, with probably about 3.5 minutes to play in the third quarter, do you recall that the score was 17-12?
I do recall that.
And it was
and
a
so
very
Hightower kind of had its hopes up
they
at
had
that
a
point.
Chance, yeah.
But since then, it's been domination by Westfield, who's just got too much for Hightower tonight. First and 10 from, let's call it, the 17. Up the middle go the Canes. 3-yard pickup to the 20-yard line. And who in the middle of that scrum has the football? And they give it to Andreas Misik Duncombe.
They're running the ball exclusively here the last couple series. They put the pass game on hold for a while, I guess.
Caleb Douglas in motion on second down and 5 after that run by Eaglin. We're nearing the 2-minute mark. Penson is going to throw it, I think. Looks at Douglas, pulls it down, takes off, picks up 1. That's it.
I knew that once I said that about putting the pass game away, the next play would be a pass.
Well, but they didn't get the pass away.
You're right. He didn't pass it, but he was in motion for the pass. And here comes the big guy who has run pretty well here in the fourth quarter, Hankins, back in the ball game.
Frederick Hankins. Trying to think of something funny to say. Something like Frederick of Hollywood, but I don't know where he's from originally.
Frederick of Most City.
Third down and four. 1:20 to go in the game. Penson hands it off and not going to get it. Oh, my goodness. Poor Hankins ran into a big mass of humanity. I'm not really sure who got him, but there's a good chance that at least partially responsible was Mason Ramos.
I think about six or seven of the defenders there got a piece of him there. Looks like they're going to try to punt this ball out of here with under a minute to play, the clock running, 40 seconds remaining. And the kicker, the left foot, he even mentioned that their kicker is left-footed, Caleb Douglas.
Well, Hightower called a timeout. Yeah, when Hightower called a timeout with 30 and 8/10 seconds left. You know who was a left-footed punter? You saw the movie The Rookie, didn't you?
Yeah.
Jimmy Morris ended up being 37 years old. Had played professional baseball when he was in his 20s, messed up his shoulder, got it fixed, but quit playing baseball, became a high school coach in West Texas, and ended up pitching parts of three seasons for the Rays as a 37-year-old rookie who could throw 98 miles an hour.
Before you continue, if you have not seen the movie, now you know what the movie's about.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Well, he was a left-footed punter for Angelo State. When he still had some eligibility to play college football, he went to Angelo State as a gray-haired punter and backup safety. And
how old was he?
Well, I guess he was probably 28, 29 at the time.
Okay.
Got his teaching certificate and went on to coach. And then the story unfolded from there. He was a left-footed punter, and he was really good at kicking at coffin corner for Angelo State.
You never hear that
out there.
You never hear that anymore. Nobody does the coffin corner anymore.
Caleb Douglas gonna punt it late, not very far, over near the Westfield bench. Almost knocked over all the cups of water. Well, the few that have not yet been
it
consumed.
Almost bounced into the bleacher area as well. He kicked it off onto the track at the 50-yard line there.
Well, this has been an outstanding game for Westfield, and Westfield folks who are listening, just know that after we finish up our live broadcast, it is podcasted about 45 minutes or an hour later, and you can listen to this thing as many times as you want. I'll try and figure out who the Booster Club leader is for Westfield and send a link to him or to her, and that link can be distributed, and you can enjoy this game over Labor Day weekend. Because you got a good football team, folks.
That is correct.
And there's a run quickly up the middle, and they've got some reserves in there. Richuk Hines is in at quarterback, and he hands it off to Ashton LeFleur. No relation to Peter LeFleur, who was in dodgeball.
All right.
But who cares, because we got 4 seconds to go.
Oh, gee, I know. You know the LeFleur that I can remember?
Guy LeFleur.
Guy LeFleur of the Montreal Canadiens.
Okay, so the game is over, Patrick, and we have survived it, but Hightower takes a loss against a very high-quality football team. And so Cornelius Anthony and his staff will get ready for next week's game. You will get ready for tomorrow night's game, which has Dulles against Willow Ridge, and you'll bring it to the people at 5:55 p.m. So anything else you want to say?
As long as I'm prepared, I will bring that game to all the folks tomorrow, and I'm looking forward to it.
And it's also my responsibility to prepare you, because you know how our equipment is.
Well,
you gotta talk to it real nice.
Right. And this is the last thing about this game. Hightower really
bang the table.
I got something to say.
See, I said our equipment does stuff.
I just want to compliment. I mean, Westfield's a great team, and I just want to compliment Hightower. Like I said, it was a 17-12 game. Late in the third, and Hightower's got some stuff going here, and I think they're going to have a good season.
And I think playing a tough opponent like this will stand them in good stead.
Absolutely.
Because in district play, they have a brutal schedule that includes Foster, Manville, and Angleton.
Let me just say this. Foster is nowhere near Westfield, so they should be able to beat Foster.
All right, well, but Foster's still pretty good.
Yeah, Foster's good.
It's just week two, so Foster is going to look – they're looking good.
Yeah, they just – but this Westfield team, I tell you what, they look pretty tough.
All right, so for Patrick Kinnick and everyone on the Vipe team, including our quality assistant, Mr. Trey Grubb, Roger Smith, saying so long from Hall Stadium in Mo City, where Westfield comes and sees and conquers by a score of 38-12 over the Hightower Hurricanes. Good night, everybody, and Patrick will bring you that game between Dulles and Willow Ridge tomorrow night. God bless you, and God bless America.